Are the Arizona Cardinals ready? Well, we'll soon find out if they're ready to meet up with the world champions and stand tall against them. They're very optimistic they'll play well on their home field as today. The Patriots meet the Cardinals at Sun Devil Stadium. Don Kroeke with Steve Tasker. Unseasonably warm, really, it's kind of mild at 89 degrees. The field temperature at 109 degrees. And normally at this time of year, it would be upwards of 130. Not a lot of ice fishing out here. It's a mild day at 109 degrees. But they're ready to go, Steve.
That's right. And the Cardinals are up against it. Dennis Green trying to install a new attitude here in Arizona, Don. And if they can beat the defending world champions when the champions have 3 days of extra preparation, that is a huge step forward for the Cardinals.
There is the deep man, Josh Scobie, for Arizona. In the 16 previous seasons they've been in the deserts, including St. Louis, the Cardinals have won three and lost 13 of their home openers. Here is Scobie, and he is taken on ball on the field, and the Patriots go after it. Looked like a Cardinal might have gotten to it. Cardinals maintain possession, so very nearly. Great field position for New England. On the opening kickoff is a Scobie coughs it up. We're ready to go with the first play from scrimmage. Last week, the Cardinals did well at St. Louis, lost to the Rams of 17-10. We look now at the opening kickoff.
Right away, the Patriots do what they do best, go right for the football. They just came up short recovering this. The Cardinals know if they want to win, they cannot turn this football over today.
Emmitt Smith, the NFL's all-on-knee rusher, still has something left in his 15th season. He averaged almost 6 yards a carry last week at St. Louis. Got 7 on that play as Tyrone Poole knocks him out of bounds. Josh McCown, the young quarterback in his 3rd year starting for the Cardinals, has not thrown a touchdown pass either in the preseason or the regular season so far. Stepanovic, the rookie center from Ohio State, been playing very well, a huge offensive line. And of course, Emmitt Smith, the preeminent runner in NFL history with the most yards ever. 15 years a running back in the NFL. Fake by McCown, a rollout, throwing on the run. He hits his tight end, and big Freddie Jones is ahead for a first down out to the 39-yard line. Ty Law gets him down, but it's an 8-yard gain. So on successive plays, the Cardinals gain 7 and 8 yards and get a first down.
It's going to be crucial for the Cardinal offense to stay on the football field today and keep Tom Brady off.
The Arizona Cardinals with a first down on this opening drive after the kickoff, which they fumbled and got back. Now they spread the field with extra wide receivers in a one-back set. They go to Emmitt Smith, and he breaks into the secondary of the Patriots, and in a first down run, that huge offensive line of Arizona opens up the Patriot run defense and another 8-yard gain. Will Fork, the rookie from Miami of Florida, number one draft choice at nose tackle. McGinnis, who had the huge sack of Manning late in the game to really put it out of reach, that long field goal. And that opening game might have been decided by the sack by McGinnis. Rodney Harrison, always a big hitter, had 3 flags called against him in that opening game. But he is a major component of a world championship team. Now on second down and a long two. Patriots align blitzers. Here they come. McCown gets some time. He's very mobile. Makes a throw and a good breakup. Coming over to make the breakup was Tyrone Poole, the 10-year veteran, number 38. Got a great young wide receiver on this Arizona team. And Larry Fitzgerald, we'll see. That's Fitzgerald going for the ball.
And you can't get it any better than that. Tyrone Poole playing it almost as though he's a big brother playing against a little brother. And Dennis Green trying to get the ball to his former ball boy in Fitzgerald. And Dennis Green has the job, as we said a little earlier. He's got to get this team, his Cardinals team, to try and beat the defending world champions, and the champions have 3 days of extra preparation. That is a tough road to hoe.
And a tough down now for the Cardinals against this Patriot defense. They go to the run on third and short and diving ahead and apparently just short of a first down on third and two. Emmitt Smith got about one, and so that would bring up fourth down and less than a yard where they're spotting the ball, and they're sending their punter out.
Yeah, a week ago, the Colts raised some eyebrows in the Thursday night game against the Patriots and getting some yardage on the ground. The Patriots maintained they didn't really mind that because they knew the Colts would sooner or later have to throw the football. They don't know exactly what to expect from this Cardinals team, and that's been a problem for Belichick in his preparation.
And now Troy Brown is back to return the punt. He'll field it at his 12. Taken down at the 15. Belichick not at all happy about his punt return game. They're still trying to find the guy. He says, we haven't gained a yard yet. It's about time to start. 40-yard punt and just a 2-yard return. There is the reigning NFL Coach of the Year, Bill Belichick. See his record, 8-3 with 9 days or more between games. He had 10 to get ready for this one. As Dennis Green said of Belichick, you know what you're going to see is something you haven't seen before. Told his players, anything they get today, they're going to have to take. They're not going to get anything. Here is Corey Dillon breaking into the open field and turning it up the far sideline. Dillon, who once ripped the Cardinals for 216 yards rushing in a single game, breaks a 17-yard gain on his first carry.
And this is why they brought Corey Dillon here. This is what they missed a year ago. If the world champions can miss anything, Corey Dillon is a big back, make no mistake. But so you can see, the Cardinals defense is a defense that has a reputation of being able to run. But Corey Dillon is a big back that is fast. And that's the most surprising thing. If you haven't seen him play before, this is a big back who can outrun people.
Well, he was at Cincinnati. Some thought he was the fastest player on the team. On first down, they go right back to Corey Dillon, a tackle breaker, 228 pounds. Another first down carry as he's out. Now they're going to spot him down penalty just short of the first down. He gets 9. As Quentin Harris and David Macklin get him down. Tom Brady with spectacular opening day numbers on September 9th. As he hit 26 of 38, 3 for touchdowns, a quarterback rating of 111. Dillon, who is really looking to get a lot of run carries today. The Cardinals have had trouble stopping the run. Brady, timing throw, puts it on the hands of his receiver, but it's knocked away. Daniel Graham, the tight end, who had a huge game against the Colts, 7 catches, 1 for a touchdown. Russell Davis, a 340-pound nose tackle, is the guy they'll try to have blocking the middle. Darling had a 95-yard return of an interception against the Rams that was called back. Dwayne Starks is a member of the Baltimore Colts World Championship team back in 2002. Came to the Cardinals as a free agent last year. Third down, less than 2. Dillon in the open field again. Corey Dillon works ahead for a gain of 4 yards and a first down out to the 45-yard line where he's taken down by Pepe Zellner.
You talk about this guy, Corey Dillon, and how good he is. He floundered in Cincinnati for 8 years. I mean, this is a guy that runs hard. He ran hard on a team that had no place to go in the playoffs. He's going to run hard for the defending world champions. Make no mistake, he is enjoying this early part of the season for the New England Patriots. He has high hopes for this club, and he wants to be part of it.
Blitzers a line now for the Cardinals as the handoff goes again to Dillon. Looks to bounce outside. His preference is to run off tackle into people. CBS Sports has added a new element to the broadcast. It's called Stat Tracks. After every play, you'll see updated stats of the offensive players involved in the play. Look for the stats coming out of the score box in the upper part of the screen. Stat Tracks will keep you updated on your fantasy players throughout the game. Ronald McKinnon, the middle linebacker, made the stop, and he, of course, told us when we met with him on Friday, Steve, that they will not run. We'll stop that.
Yeah, the Cardinals can run. They've got fast linebackers, and up front, they're built to pursue. But thus far, Corey Dillon has had a good first quarter.
Second and 9. Long ball. Patton going after it, but no one's close to it. As with a gusting wind at his back up to 25 miles an hour, the long ball by Brady is way too long.
And that's as far away from his receiver as you'll ever see Tom Brady throw a football. You never see him miss a receiver that far, even if it is a 60-yard throw like that one was. Tom Brady is one of those guys, and the most impressive thing about him is when he's back there at quarterback, you don't feel like he needs to throw the football. He will. He can if you want him to. But he's an unselfish quarterback, and Charlie Weiss knows he's got a special guy because he's just as happy handing it off as he is throwing the football.
Yeah, Brady's the best in the game at the only stat that matters, winning. Now from the shotgun, a hard throw over the middle, and the ball is up for play and incomplete. So the Cardinals come hitting hard on David Patton as Brady fired in a fastball at him. Adrian Wilson, one of the safeties, was there to make the hit. They've got big, hard-hitting safeties on the Cardinals.
Well, one of the things the Cardinals would love to get pressure on Tom Brady. They feel like they could get some, make some hay against him if they can get somebody in his lap. He had plenty of time to throw that football and yet couldn't complete the pass.
Here's the punt now, hit downfield by Josh Miller. And it heads down towards the end zone and goes in for a touchback. Dexter Reed, try as he might to down it inside the two, couldn't do it. So the Cardinals will have it for a second time when we come back to the Valley of the Sun.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 39. Dr. Pepper and your Dr. Pepper bottler. Be you, nothing's better, Dr. Pepper. And by IBM, making on-demand business a reality for companies around the world.
We're back to the Valley of the Sun. No score, first quarter, the Patriots and the Cardinals. This field was the site of a huge upset last night as the Sun Devils of Arizona State routed number 16, Iowa, 44-7. Now McCown looks to throw on first down. A hard throw on the flank is beautifully executed as the ball is completed out across the 30-yard line. Larry Fitzgerald, who caught four last week, all for first downs, makes the play.
He's working there against Ty Law. Ty Law is as experienced a cornerback as you'll find in the National Football League, working with one of the guys with the least amount of experience in the NFL, and the rookie comes out on top. Larry Fitzgerald is not just a young guy. He's got a lot of poise and a lot of ability, and he's been around professional athletes since he was a kid.
Well, he was the third pick in the entire draft coming out of Pittsburgh, and they think he's every bit as good as advertised, and now a big play in the backfield, and the ball is... Carrier is knocked down by Vrabel as Emmitt Smith is hit by Vrabel, and there's a loss of a couple of yards on the play.
And you can bet that the New England Patriots took a little heat and for the yards they gave up in their last game against the Colts. They had to find a way to fix the running game that they gave up and the yards that they gave up in the running game a week ago. And Bill Belichick didn't seem all that concerned because they were willing to concede a little bit of that against the Colts. But this is a different team than the Cardinals, and they have a different game plan. Stopping the run is more important even this week.
Both these defenses gave a lot of run yardage up on opening day. Here's a sidearm throw and incomplete as McCown whips the ball in sidearm to the big tight end Fred Jones and Eugene Wilson. A really good young safety in his second year, especially good versus the short and intermediate pass routes. Good cover skills, breaks it up.
You watch there, and Jones was thinking he got hit a little early there by Wilson. I didn't see it. It was a good play by Wilson. Throw his ball was a little behind him, I think, out of necessity. But I think McCown was still a little bit late in letting that football go. He's got to throw it a little faster to give his guy a chance to make a play on it.
That's been one of the problems he's had, Steve, being a young quarterback, that he holds the ball too long a lot. Right now, he's got a lot of yards to get on the third and 12, and the Patriots align blitzers. Here comes Bruschi, delayed blitz. Penalty markers thrown as McCown heads for the 12th man and tiptoes the sideline. Living dangerously, stays in bounds, but he's still 9 yards short of a first down.
There's a penalty flag in the backfield of the Patriots as you saw it come in there as McCown tried to buy time, but you know, this is the kind of situation the Cardinals can't afford. Third and 13, they have got to do better than that.
Offense number 71. This penalty is declined. Result for the play, fourth down.
At the center holding, Stepanovic. Declined by the Patriots, and so the Cardinals will punt for a second time. And again, Troy Brown is back for New England, standing at his 20. Scott Player, the punter, had punted very well. Eight punts last week against the Rams, averaged almost 43 yards a punt. Gets it up into the wind and still drives it deep. Brown from the 10. 15. 20, 25, out to the 32-yard line. So a 22-yard punt return by Troy Brown. 55-yard punt, then the 22-yard return. And the Patriots are ready to go on offense again in a moment. Pat Tillman and one of the countless brave men and women who have made the ultimate sacrifice in service of their country, the former Cardinal, as the Corey Dillon goes to the run and gains about 5 yards. Pat Tillman, of course, was a seventh-round draft pick of the Cardinals. Now to become a starter, set the single-season record for tackles, 224, and then gained even greater acclaim when he walked away from pro football to enlist in the Army in the spring of 2002. Pat was killed in the line of duty last April while serving as an Army Ranger in Afghanistan, becoming the first NFL to be killed in combat since the Vietnam War. Today, throughout the league, players on every team wear a sticker number 40 on their helmet in honor of Pat Tillman, an American hero. Incomplete throw, looking at David Givens. There's a penalty marker down in the backfield.
Yeah, they tried to get a little extra shot on Tom Brady, and if there's a quarterback in the National Football League you don't want to take an extra shot on, if there's a guy they want to protect, it's Tom Brady.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense number 51. Unnecessary roughness, came in late. 15-yard penalty, first down.
The blitz was perfectly picked up by the Patriots, and that's a launch, left his feet, hit him low, but you can't hit him. After that, he left his feet, that's a penalty, it's always going to be a penalty. And they're trying to get, you get the feeling this Cardinal team would like to get in Brady's head a little bit, get him a little uncomfortable in the pocket. They haven't done it yet.
As anybody. It's a tough head to get inside. He's able to block out the world and concentrate. Here's a handoff, and Dillon again gets ahead for plus yards on a first down carry down to the 43-yard line. Monday, on an all-new Late Show, for the first time ever, Dave goes one-on-one with presidential candidate John Kerry. That's on Monday. And on Tuesday, Dave's got Dr. Phil right here on CBS. So far, Steve, Corey Dillon off to a good start. 6 carries, 40 yards. Brady's 0 for 3 throwing the ball so far.
This is one of those seasons where that's a guy you got to cheer for, Corey Dillon. You saw him go 3-13 and 4-12 in Cincinnati. You kind of wish the best for him this season as a Patriot.
Comes out of the backfield. Ball is thrown to him, and he has to make a diving catch for no gain. Again, pressure is on Brady.
You know, you and I talked to Corey Dillon, and you hear this from a lot of guys. He came in and sat down, and we said, "You're going to like it here in New England." He said, "Well, you know, I was in Cincinnati for all those years." And, you know, you always wonder, all the players wonder, is the grass really green or someplace else? And he answered it. What was it he said?
He said, "I got to New England, I found out it's pretty green."
The grass is pretty green in New England.
I've always loved the guy's attitude, so have you. I mean, he just got tired of losing at Cincinnati.
We've had nothing but positive experiences with him.
Brady lobs a beautiful throw. Moving quickly is Deion Branch. And Branch is very close to a first down. It looks like the spot is going to be favorable for the Patriots. Deion Branch, who had 7 catches, 1 for a touchdown in the opener against the Colts.
And still, Tom Brady has all the time in the world. Finds Branch across the middle, and then it's up to Branch just to find a crease just to get that first down. He does it, stays alive, and dives for the first down. But Tom Brady, in the time he had, just took, you know, it looked easy. And let Branch make a play. That's a good quarterback. Brady knows if he gets it to the right guy, he's got enough room to make that first down.
Well, every defensive coordinator knows Brady will go to a minimum of 8, maybe as many as 10 different receivers in the game. So it puts tremendous pressure on the defense the way he can check down. Now he can't do anything as they get the big rush. And coming hard is Ross Kalaji, a huge defensive tackle from Wisconsin. And Brady is sacked back at the 46-yard line of Arizona.
Well, Arizona sends 6 guys after Brady, and one of them finally gets there. You see there. Yeah, that's Adrian Wilson, the safety, coming up, getting in Brady's head, scared him off. They lost 8 on the play, and that's the kind of play the Cardinals have to make. We'll see if the Patriots can make plays against man-to-man coverage in the secondary. If Brady has time, you know this team can do it.
And Dennis Green said the formation that really troubles him was that the Patriots go with two tight ends and two wide receivers. Said out of that, Brady can throw so many things at you. It's so hard to defend. Here is a screen pass near side. And on the run is Patrick Pass, and he loses the ball. Ball on the field, up for play. Patriots might have gotten it back inside the 10.
He did. Wow. And that's something you've got to take advantage of. Branch comes up with the fumble. Three Cardinals had a shot at it, and they all tried to get it. They hurried too much. You got to be relaxed when you're going for a fumble. You see, this is the great play. You see, that's Pass coming out, and he gets hit right on the ball, pops clean out. No question, it's a fumble. Now, just relax. Take your time, scoop the ball up, and they don't. It goes right through him, right to Branch. You can say it's a lucky bounce, Don. Good teams take advantage of how the ball bounces, whether it's lucky or not.
So the pass was a 27-yard gain. The fumble recovery was 11 yards more downfield. The Patriots are first and goal, and here's Dillon attacking down to the 5-yard line. Yeah, you see a lot of times linemen, I mean, they're so anxious to get in the end zone, they'll try to pick it up, and they stumble all over. That time he did fall on, but couldn't recover.
It sounds funny, but when the ball is on the ground bouncing around, the thing you don't want to do is hurry. You can hustle, but don't hurry. Take your time and make sure the play is made before you do anything. And on that case, you have three guys running right over the top of the football and leaving it for their opponent to pick up. And Branch was smart enough to be there and hustle to the football.
Branch just saves the day early on. And the Patriots now in position to score, second and goal from the 5. Roll out. Brady searching out a receiver. He's in trouble. Throws the ball up and a bit too high just before he is leveled. Again, coming up to put pressure on him was Kalaji, also on the rush, Bert Berry.
Thought for a moment there was a flag on the play. There's a big conference of officials. And there is a flag in the defensive backfield.
Well, as Dennis Green says,
first down.
And it's going to be first and goal on the 3-yard line for the Patriots.
Almost to the 2. Dennis Green says winning comes in cycles and losing comes in cycles. And he said, you know what cycle the Patriots are on. He said it's rare in this league for anybody to win 6 games in a row, let alone 16 games in a row.
It's a culture, Don. Your locker room and your coaching staff create that kind of culture where that's what you expect and that's what you get.
First and goal for the Patriots. Brady takes a look, throws to the back of the end zone, touchdown New England. Down with the ball is tight end Daniel Graham. 8th catch of the year, he had 7 against the Colts.
And as you can tell at home, there are a lot of Patriots fans who made the trek to the desert this weekend for the Patriots game.
Boy, are there.
You see, this is, watch how poised Brady is. He'll come back. He's got flash right. He doesn't turn and run. He just backpedals. And you notice when the rush comes in his face, he never looks at it. His eyes are always downfield. And that's unbelievable when you've got guys breathing down your neck.
So the Patriots capitalize, getting back their own fumble. And now the extra point by Vinatieri is up and good. And so New England jumps out to a 7-0 lead. The Cardinals' worst nightmare. They don't catch up well.
NFL on CBS is sponsored by T-Mobile. Get more minutes, more features, more service. And by Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light, the official beer sponsor of the NFL and Super Bowl 39.
After going 0-for-3 passing on the Patriots opening drive, Tom Brady goes 4-for-4 on that drive, hitting Daniel Graham, the big tight end, for a touchdown from 2 yards out to culminate a 68-yard drive in 8 plays. Kickoff is deep, and Scobie elects to bring it out. Protecting the ball, he's down to the 15-yard line, so he sets his team in deep field position. 85 yards from the Patriot end zone, the tackle by Banta Kane. Now the Cardinals have to try to come back, and McCown's going to have to start throwing the ball more. With Steve Tasker, this is Don Crickey back at Sun Devil Stadium, Tempe, Arizona. Patriots on a 2-yard touchdown throw. Brady to Graham, lead the game 7-0. McCown at quarterback of the one-back offense. Rolling out to throw, very mobile, strong of arm. But the heat's on. McCown now has to run and head for the sideline. And he persists in staying in bounds and taking hits. Have to admire his courage, if not his discretion. Wednesday on CBS, it's a Dr. Phil primetime event. Think you know how your kids act when you're not around? You might be surprised. Plus, a family that could be raising a serial killer. Don't miss the Dr. Phil primetime special, Wednesday at 8, 7 Central, here on CBS.
Just remember this, Don. I act perfectly nice when you're not around.
Okay. It's those five little taskers you can.
Yeah.
Second down and 11. You talk about a bad turn of events. He tripped on his center's foot, did the McCown, and all of it coming on a safety blitz was Harrison, and he was a sitting duck.
Yeah, a couple of things came together for the worse for Josh McCown on that. Watch right in front of your screen. Rodney Harrison comes around, McCown trips, and bang, right in his face. You watch this. There's just nothing there to stop him. He's going to come in. Emmitt Smith takes the big guy, McGinnis. But he can't get both of them.
Almost helmet to helmet. Rodney sends a message. We talked to him Friday, and he said our game plan is we're going to stop their run, that they won't run.
Yeah, and when in doing so, it even means that they may go man-to-man on the outside and challenge the receivers, the Cardinals. We've seen a lot of man-to-man early on by the Patriots, and you can bet we're going to see more of it the way things are going defensively in this series.
Right now, the Cardinals in some disarray on offense have to signal for and get a timeout to give their young quarterback some counsel. Shannon Sharp has joined our CBS team, and he's also joined the team at NFL.com. Log on and read Shannon's thoughts on this week's action in the NFL, as only he can tell it. It's all at NFL.com or at NFL on AOL.
If you watch NFL today, you heard Shannon say he would rather die in an abandoned building than play for Tom Coughlin in New York.
Without his family knowing where he was.
It's a strong statement.
But Coughlin with the last laugh today. His Giants beat the favorite Redskins. Now a ball is sent back at McCown, slapped back. Eddie Bruschi, who has strong roots here in Arizona, was a great one for the University of Arizona, that famed Desert Swarm defense.
And I'll tell you what, you want to talk about a guy with a nose for the football. Teddy Bruschi is him. I mean, wherever the football is, it seems that he knows where it's going to be a half second before
offside.
It gets there.
Defense number 38 in the neutral zone at the snap. 5-yard penalty will repeat third down.
They had everybody at the line of scrimmage. It seemed like it was a team meeting right at the football. And the Patriots were lined up in the middle. You'll see right there. He's going to jump over. And I didn't see that. He seemed to be off the line of scrimmage. They must have missed the number of the jersey on that one.
Kenny Green says Belichick will show you things you're not ready for in the first quarter, make adjustments, and keep showing you new things in the second, third, and fourth quarters on defense. Now third and a long of almost 12. McCown makes a throw downfield. It's picked. Patriots have the ball in an open field. Eugene Wilson, the young safety, turns the corner, runs the ball back inside the 35-yard line, down to the 30, where he's knocked out of bounds by Carl Williams. And so the Patriots dominating early. An interception by Eugene Wilson and a subsequent 14-yard return.
It's a bad decision by McCown to throw this football down the middle of the field. He's trying to find Larry Fitzgerald. He throws this ball over his head. There's just no room. Three defenders right around him. Even Larry Fitzgerald couldn't jump up to get that. And here comes Poole the other way. Actually, Wilson the other way. And that was a bad decision, a bad throw. You're even better just to throw that into the ground rather than turn it over.
Sure, he wishes he had a chance to do that now. That's his first interception of the year. And now Brady with great field position for his offense, starting at the 30. Dillon. Breaking tackles. Dennis Green said, unless you hit Corey Dillon with more than one guy, he'll kill you running the ball. One tackler won't get him, an 8-yard gain.
Well, Corey Dillon has a reputation for being a guy who breaks tackles. When you stand next to him, you understand why. Like, I mean, the guy is big. and he can run, and he's just, he's one of those slippery runners, Don. He's not like a Barry Sanders or one of the small guys that moves sideways. This guy runs straight ahead. He'll change direction, but not sharp. You'll get a piece of him, but you better get a big piece of him or he'll shrug you off.
In the first quarter, he got a big piece of them, rushing for 51 yards on 8 carries. End of the first quarter, the Patriots in the lead, 7-0. We'll return to Sun Devil Stadium after these messages. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Back and ready to start the second quarter at Sun Devil Stadium. Tom Brady with his team, second down in the long two. Leading 7-0. Dillon again, more plus yards. They can't stop him. Dillon hammered from behind, is pushed forward for another 2 yards. And it's first and goal for the Patriots at the 9-yard line. Dansby, a rookie backer from Auburn, gets him down. But that was a 13-yard gain and 64 yards rushing.
Corey Dillon's the perfect back for this type of game, Don. You get a lead, you're on the road, and you just use him like a hammer. It's an old cliche to say a back is a hammer. He's like a chrome-plated sledgehammer. Not only does he get the job done, he looks good doing it. And this offensive line is playing extremely well. They're being very patient in every phase of the game, pass and run, and Corey Dillon's going to get the ball a lot.
He's getting it a lot today. He's run 9 times for 64 yards. This time they cut him down for no gain. It'll be second and goal from the 9. Dillon with tremendous rushing numbers. He averaged 5.7 to carry in the opening win over the Colts. He's averaging 6.5 yards, almost 7 yards today.
And this is where the Cardinals are going to be looking around. They're saying, listen, we've got to stop the tide right now because they're not built, as you mentioned earlier, to catch up. They're not built to come from behind. They've got to stop the Patriots and find a way somehow, some way, or this game will get out of hand on them.
Now they've got a problem. 5 wide receiver set, an open backfield for Brady. He can usually find the guy before you can get to him. Here comes the rush. Brady steps in and dodges the rush, makes a throw. Hit ball twice and incomplete. There is a penalty marker down where Brady was hit. It's against the Patriots.
And you see there the poise of Brady. I mean, this guy has a guy hanging around his neck, shrugs it off, still keeps his eyes down the field, doesn't cut and run, tries to find a receiver, and almost completes the pass. And that's really frustrating for a defense. I mean, this team was pounding away with Corey Dillon, pounding, and all of a sudden they show up in 5 wideouts and no back, and you're thinking, wait a minute, now what?
So referee Coretti.
Illegal use of the hands, hands of the face, offense, number 70. 10-yard penalty, repeat, second down.
Adrian Clem called for hands to the face, so that sets the Patriots back.
You see out here at left tackle, he comes off and he gets his hands up in the face. He's pulling the face. Yeah, that's, you're going to call that. And, you know, so much goes on in that offensive line, Don. It's almost, you almost don't want to talk about it.
It's that bad. Second down now, and goal from the 20. End zone throw, open receiver, but Patrick Pass can't get to the ball. The fullback pass comes out of the backfield, and the ball leads him by about a yard too much.
You know, Brady let this one go, and then he just looked at the ground and walked off. He missed, fired it, and you'll see. This is a fullback running the corner out. Watch Brady throws it, and he just drops his head and walks away, and you figure, golly, how does a guy get that open? And that's why this Patriot offense is so difficult to beat. You got a lot of guys who can do a lot of things. A fullback running a deep route just doesn't happen for most teams.
And now we have a break in the action as one of the Cardinals is down. So he's being attended to. We'll have this timeout. We're back. Burt Barry, who had 11 and a half sacks last year with the Denver Broncos and came here as a free agent, shaken up, appears to be all right. Third and goal from just inside the Cardinal 20. Brady standing in, makes a throw, open receiver, touchdown Patriots. Again, he goes to his tight end Daniel Graham on a crossing pattern. He's left uncovered, officially a 19-yard touchdown throw, and the Patriots go to a 13-0 lead.
Don, that's the identical play that they just missed completing to Patrick Pass on the other side. And Graham comes up, runs the identical route. This time, Brady doesn't miss. and the Cardinals missed the coverage once again. The same route, two different ways. It was open both times. And Tom Brady giving two tries at a pass like that, he's going to hit one of them.
Well, he just hit it for his fifth touchdown pass of the season. Vinatieri is up and good with the extra point. We'll watch again Daniel Graham, the former Colorado Buffalo, with 9 catches this year, 3 for touchdowns.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by the Star Wars Trilogy for the first time on DVD September 21st. Subway, living well and eating well is about making choices. We're glad we're one of them. Subway, choose well. And by Cadillac and the all-new STS, breakthrough.
Tom Brady, searching out the open man, finds Graham again for a second touchdown throw. And now Scobie bobbles the kickoff, finds a gap and breaks it. And takes it out across the 25-yard line, out close to the 28 before Larry Izzo gets him down. So an early bobble results in a 28-yard return. Monday on CBS, it's a season premiere so intense, one CSI investigator won't survive it. CSI Miami, Monday at 10, 9 Central on CBS. America's most watched network. See the scoring drive. It happened fast.
This is the key thing. Dylan, 3 rushes for 21 yards. It seems like when they need him, he can turn it on and get it. And that's a huge advantage for the Patriots in the early going here.
He's rushed 10 times today, has Corey Dillon, for 64 yards. And Emmitt Smith trying to pick his way. And all he finds is 345-pound Vince Wilfork.
Well, teams saw the Patriots play that opening game against Indianapolis, and they gave up a lot of yards on the ground. We talked to Belichick and some of the defenders and said, you know what, we did that because we doggedly would not put 8 guys in the box against Indianapolis. We wanted them to run the football against us because if we put 8 guys in the box, Marvin Harrison would have beaten us quickly. So this week, they're not averse to putting 8 guys in the box if they need it. They haven't needed it yet.
Another pick as McCown tries to fire a quick flat pass. And while we have a moment, that was Larry Fitzgerald. Incomplete. Let's go to Greg Gumbel now, New York, for the Bills and the Raiders. Raiders on the board.
All right, Don, 2 teams looking for their first win of the season. Rich Gannon looking for and finding Ronald Curry behind the secondary. 43 yards and the touchdown. The Raiders with the extra point. Lead at 7-0, second quarter. Don and Steve, back to you.
Thank you, Greg. Yeah, the Bills coming off an improbable last-second loss on their home field when they seemed to have it won last week against Jacksonville. Now in serious danger of starting 0-2.
Somebody said it ain't over till it's over. He was right.
Which one is that? This one or that? Here now rolling out is McCown, and he is just absolutely outmatched by the Patriot defense. Totally discombobulated, doesn't know where to go. Starting to look at the rush. He's looking at one guy, Larry Fitzgerald, the rookie. But all he saw was Dan Klecko and Vrabel ready to sweep him under.
McCown couldn't even get back to his drop before he had 3 Patriots right in his face. He ran for his life and just got rid of it. That is not a good sign for the offensive line of the Cardinals.
Troy Brown, who had a 22-yard punt return the last time. Back again. Ball put up high in a gusting wind from the 29. Brown turns wide, and he'll lose 3 or 4 yards. So the 43-yard punt and a 3-yard loss on the return. Dansby was on the tackle. It's not too late to play fantasy football. To play now, just log on to CBSSportsLine.com and click on Fantasy Football. Patriots getting it back on a punt, ready to go back to work with that 2 tight end, 1 back formation that Green says is so tough to defend. Brady pointing to a possible blitzer stepping in, making sure his linemen know who to pick up. Hand off to Dillon, nothing happening, no gain. Macklin comes up along with Carlos Dansby. Dansby, a rookie from Auburn, making a lot of plays. 58 and 27, Macklin, the former Colt, who came out here as a free agent.
And it's the first really spark of life you've seen out of the Cardinal defense, stopping Corey Dillon for a loss on that play. And you got to wonder, had to make some defensive adjustments, and there's the difference. Corey Dillon's got 64 yards by himself. Arizona, all told, has 34.
There's a timing throw in the flat. Breaking it is David Givens. He's ahead for a first down as he's out of bounds outside the 40-yard line of the Patriots. A 14-yard gain. David Givens, who had four catches, averaging 20 yards a catch in the opener against the Colts.
This is what a quarterback absolutely loves. Throw the ball out there, let your guy break a tackle, and you know, this all goes on Tom Brady's statistics, but he has receivers, and you talk about the receivers that are the Patriots, they're all kind of alike. I mean, they're able to catch the ball in traffic, break a tackle, and you know, it gives Tom Brady a sense of continuity with the whole core. They're all exactly like, he has confidence in all of them.
And he finds them all. He checks down to everybody. Here's Dillon working hard as they now stack the run defense against him. Those linebackers jamming up and looking for Dillon.
Yeah, we talk about the receivers of the Patriots. This is them. I mean, look, they're 5'9 and 5'10. The big guy, David Givens, is the only 6-footer, and they all weigh about the same. They're all within 10 or 15 pounds. And I think that's one of the reasons why they're all so versatile, and that's one of the things you talk to these Patriots and the guys they like to play on their team. They can all do more than one thing. When you got five guys like that who can do more than one thing, wow, that's a huge matchup problem.
And not a first-round draft choice among those five productive receivers. Pitch back, and there's going to be a false start, I would think, called against the Patriots. Bert, we'll see. And that might be Bert Berry. We'll let Tony Corrente figure this out.
You know, so many of these teams have this big number one receiver like a Terrell Owens or a Randy Moss. The Patriots are doing it with a bunch of guys who can do everything at once.
Neutral zone infraction on the defense, number 92.
Was Bert Berry.
Neutral zone causing an offensive lineman to lift. 5-yard penalty remains, second down.
You see there, that's why it's a penalty on the defense. He made, you know, he's the guy that jumped. It wasn't Matt Light jumping off sides early. He reacted to the defender, and that's why it's a penalty on Berry.
And that makes it second and three at the 48-yard line. Brady so far is 6 of 10 throwing the ball for 61 yards and two touchdowns, both to tight end Daniel Graham. Ben Watson, the rookie tight end, is not playing today. Banged up a knee net badly in the opening win, so he's being held out today. Dillon puts the ball on the field. It's live. Once again, we have guys bungling their way all the way down to the 10-yard line. They did recover it. It's first down and first and 10 from the 11-yard line. So Macklin and Wilson both fighting for the ball, knocking it free. And the Cardinals get a much-needed break to get back in this game if they can.
Corey Dillon never has the handle on this. It just pops out immediately, and then he tries to, like, almost kick it out of bounds because he knows he's not going to be able to scoop it. Tries to do the smart thing, get rid of it. And there you see, we talked about earlier, just take your time and pick the football up. And finally, Berry does get the handle on it, and then, of course, the tight end Graham comes over and saves the day. And that's, you know, you can't forego points in this. Every defensive coordinator in the National Football League will tell you, I don't care if it's on the 1-foot line, stop it. Give us a chance to stop it for a field goal try. Don't give up the touchdown.
McCown so far has shown no indication he can move the team effectively. Emmitt Smith looks for a gap. Not back. He got about 2 yards from the 11 to the 9. Lead tackler was Ty Warren, 94.
It's going to be, Don, I can't put enough emphasis on this. If the Cardinals can punch this football in this situation, they've got a chance. If they don't, or if the unthinkable happens, they come away with no points, that will absolutely be a huge blow to Dennis Green and his sidelines. I mean, it'll be tough for them to bounce back from an opportunity like this missed.
Well, they're announcing, it looks like, Steve, they're going to try to run the ball. Double tight ends, one wide receiver. High set in the backfield. They're going to throw out of it, but first they're going to get sacked out of it.
Unbelievable. They broke the play. The backs went one way. McCown went the other. Absolutely a botched play.
McCown, when Dennis Green arrived, their loss of 9 there, he said McCown's good enough to win with, and he had the 3rd pick in the draft, and he passed over guys like Philip Rivers and Lothwisberger and Lossman, 3 other quarterbacks, and went in the first round and went with a wide receiver.
You know, it's hard to figure out what happened on that play. The offensive line goes to the right, McCown goes to the right, and both backs, Emmitt Smith and Ion Badejo, go left. I mean, yet half the team going one way and half the team going the other. Who was right, who was wrong? And now they have to take a timeout.
And that was the ever-dangerous Willie McGinnis putting the heat on McCown. So they called another timeout. Now they find themselves at the 18-yard line of the Patriots.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Lowe's, where you'll find all your home improvement needs. Lowe's, improving home improvement. And by Hummer. Check out the H2 at Hummer.com. Hummer, like nothing else.
A moment ago, the Cardinals trying to make something happen. The offensive line moves to the right. The backs move this way, and McCown moves that way. Who knows what this play was supposed to look like, but for the Cardinals, it wasn't supposed to look like that.
Well, the Cardinals right now, they just can't solve this changing Patriot defense. Re-snap, it looks like one thing, and the ball is snapped. It's something altogether different. Must look to McCown like there's 22 guys on the other side of the ball running around. Look at faking blitzes, bringing blitzes. Here's another one. McCown is dropped, loses the ball, and falls on the back of the 34. And at this point, Josh McCown is really not ready to play against a defense this good.
And that's out of field goal range.
Yeah.
I mean, that's going to be a 51-yarder. And you'll watch, here's McCown comes out. And you said it, Don. What the Patriots are doing is moving around pre-snap. McCown has no idea exactly where that defensive front's going to be. And you know, if McCown doesn't know, neither does his offensive line.
Right.
They're letting guys run free right into his lap, and they are going to try this field goal.
Well, it's got to be scary for any quarterback, those blitzers coming off the edge unblocked.
They lost 22 yards on that drive.
51-yard try and a swirling wind. Raptors is strong of leg. He hits the ball long enough, and he drives it through, so a 51-yard field goal by Neil Rackers, who had a great preseason and hit one of one last week. And the Cardinals do have a kicking game, and they're down 14-3. We're back as Josh McCown looking at some printouts, guys drawing stuff for him. Nothing can solve a defense that he hasn't got enough experience to handle yet. So far, the Patriots have 118 total yards. The Cardinals have 12. Bethel Johnson, who averaged 28 yards a kickoff return last year as a rookie, second best in the NFL, brings it out to the 26. A marker comes in.
One of the few mistakes the Patriots have made thus far. They'll send them back inside their own 20-yard line, and there's Bill Belichick. I mean, let me tell you about Bill Belichick. You were there when we sat down with him, Don, on Friday. He comes into the meeting.
During the return of the kick, holding, receiving team number 53, 10-yard penalty, first down.
He comes into the meeting as the head coach of the defending world champions after just winning the opening game over the probably one of the best teams in his conference. He sits down, and the first words out of his mouth are, "We have to play better in all phases of the game."
Yep.
And he
was true. His mindset.
You could tell he wasn't putting it on. I mean, that's, you know, you want to know why his team is good. They have expectations that are different than everybody else's.
Well, high expectations, and they've been met as Corey Dillon runs the ball and gets about 4 yards. The final season of Everybody Loves Raymond is about to begin. And just so you know, we saved the best for last. Don't miss in the season premiere of Everybody Loves Raymond, Monday at 9, 8 Central, here on CBS. James Darling was on the last stop, and that brings up second down and 4, almost 5. Brady pump fakes, puts up a timing throw. It's up for a pick. They intercept. Macklin picks it off. Now the Cardinals get a pick off of Brady, a lofted ball, and Brady was hit hard after he released the ball. He was looking at David Gibbons, but Macklin with good man coverage goes up and gets it.
And this is what the Cardinals wanted to do. They've got to get pressure on Brady. He had to let this go with a pump fake. He had no choice. He couldn't pull this ball back because he had a guy in his lap. He was looking for help from Givens, maybe to knock this ball away. Watch as he throws this. He's got to get rid of it. He has no choice. He doesn't want to take the sack. And he threw it up for grabs and needed a little help, and he couldn't get it in that situation. So for the first time, the pressure finally that they were able to get paid off for the Cards.
And the run, Emmitt Smith weaving his way inside the 40 down to the 36. A phenomenal contributor in his career, a guy who was 8 times a Pro Bowl player. Emmitt Smith, former MVP of the league, former MVP of the Super Bowl, a first ballot Hall of Famer. And they say maybe his greatest attribute is his leadership in the locker room when he was with the Cowboys and here.
Yeah, a lot of great players don't have that reputation, but Emmitt Smith was beloved by the guys he played with. And there's only one way to do that, Don. You show up every day and you work hard. And that's the one way to earn that kind of respect in this league, and he's done it year in, year out.
Belichick says he's produced at every level. He was a great high school player, great college player at Florida, and the all-time leading rusher in the NFL. Every season, every place he's been, he's a producer.
And you hear people talk about him saying this may be his last season, and maybe he shouldn't have held on, maybe he shouldn't have signed with the Cardinals 2 years ago. But when you have a player like Emmitt Smith, and you want, and everybody thinks, well, it's time for him to retire, you know, they're asking the guy to do something that's against his nature. I mean, these guys play, and they're great because they do not quit ever. So when it comes to the end, you can kind of forgive him maybe if he wants an extra year.
Well, he's playing because he loves it. He's extraordinarily successful off the field. Here is McCown on the run. Tucks the ball in, gets to the 35-yard line. And that brings up another fourth down. So here comes the field goal team.
And this is going to be another long attempt.
Real long. How about this is going to be about 52.
52. And that, he hit the last one, had plenty of leg. And they have the wind at their back.
Yeah, the wind has switched. The wind was going the other way before the game. Now it's at the back of the Cardinals. A 52-yard attempt for Neil Rackers, an ex-Cincinnati Bengal. He can kick it far. No question about that. Spins it up. Does it have enough? It does. Rackers with a sensational day. 3 for 3 on the year. 2 field goals today, both over 50 yards. Giving the Cardinal fans something to cheer about as they cut into the Patriot lead 14-6. Next Saturday, the Home Depot SEC on CBS puts on the Crimson Tide and the Arkansas Razorbacks. It'll all begin with Tim Brando and Spencer Tillman on TIAA Kreft College Football Today. It's coming up next Saturday. As right now, look at the Bama. They won big last night. Arkansas, a lot of crimson on that field.
A lot of great football in the college ranks yesterday. Also happened to notice that Northwestern University beat the University of Kansas.
They did.
Yes, they did.
Congratulations. You're a former Wildcat.
My alma mater finally beat my wife's alma mater. I mean,
also distinguish yourself with the Dodge City Conquistadors.
Yes, I did.
Dodge City Junior College and the Buffalo Bills, 7 times a Pro Bowler.
You laugh, but one of the teams that I played against was the team that Corey Dillon also played against. Corey Dillon, product of the community college ranks out of Garden City. A lot of good football players down there, and that's an impressive stat right there. 2 over 50 yards.
Yeah, that's real impressive.
I mean, that's, you need a guy like that to win.
Rackers booms the ball deep into the end zone. F.L. Johnson cautioned not to bring it out. And it'll come out on a touchback to the 20-yard line. So 5:13 left to play in the first half. Coming up on the Nextel Halftime Report, join Greg, Dan, Shannon, and Boomer for all the latest NFL scores and highlights. That's all coming up on the Nextel Halftime Report. Cardinals in the game, thanks to their place kicker and the turnover.
You know, at this point, just before halftime, Don, you watch as these players take the field. The Cardinals are still jogging out to their huddle. Now the Patriots are kind of walking around. They take their time to get to the huddle. They're really, really turning down the volume on their hustle in between plays.
Brady looking to air it out on first down, and over the middle throw. He hits his receiver in mid-stride. And David Patton is all the way out to the 43-yard line, a gain of 24 yards on the play. Wilson and Macklin bring him down.
And this is another one of those wide receivers. This is Patton on the outside, comes underneath the clear out route by Troy Brown. And it's a basic principle. You get one guy to go, the defense goes with him, and then right underneath him, you bring your other receiver. There's always a void there.
Temperature going down. It was 109 on the field at kickoff. And as we said at the outset, that is almost cool for this time of year. It's normally over 120 on the field in September. Handoff, a driving run by Dillon, takes the ball to the 50 on a first down carry. He gets 7.
And watch this, Corey Dillon. You want to talk about patience. He comes in, takes the handoff, and watch where his right hand is, right in the middle of the back of his offensive guard there. That's Joe Andruzzi. And he just follows him in, and you run in the wake of the big boat behind you, you know, in front of him. And that's just, the back is being patient, and he's a huge back. It's like trying to tackle 600 pounds.
A workmanlike day as they pound Dillon again on a second and short. He gets about a yard and a half. Dillon averaging over 5.5 yards a carry today. He's getting the ball a lot. 16 carries, 79 yards.
Every time you talk about a running back, it's, you know, it starts with his offensive line. It's interesting, the Patriots are the only team I know of that when they get into a game like this, they play 7 offensive linemen. They play every offensive lineman. You hear about defenses platooning, but one of the things the Patriots do is they play extra offensive linemen to give their guys a chance to keep fresh.
And on third and short, Brady calls his own number, digs in behind center Dan Copen and drives ahead for a Patriot first down. Darnell Dockett was the tackler, a rookie from Florida State, who they think could be the defensive rookie of the year. They got him in the third round. He, as a junior, was projected as one of the top guys to come out. Slipped a little bit on his performance that year, but they think he could be a great player, over 300 pounds. Brady with constantly changing formations. Dennis Green says, show you the unexpected, and they keep changing. Brady gets time, steps in, delivers to a, oh man, Patton was wide open, but then it was almost picked. A bit underthrown as LeVar Woods, number 56. Dennis Green says, if everyone we had played with his attitude, his intensity, we'd be a playoff team.
You watch here, you can see what Tom Brady sees. He thought he was gonna get it all the way over Woods. Woods extends into the air and knocks it down. He's mad he didn't come up with it. That's the kind of play the Cardinals need their linebackers to make, not just to bat that ball down, but to come down with it.
LeVar Woods, a fourth-year linebacker from Iowa, makes a big play. That would have gone a long way had he been able to get the ball to Patton. Brady on second and 10 from the shotgun. Blitzer. And Brady does the right thing, throws it at the feet of a receiver. It would have been a loss if he caught it. But it is no grounding.
That's an illustration not only of Tom Brady, but it's also an illustration of a smart play. I mean, Tom Brady comes out, there's the play's shut off from the very beginning. The Cards have the right defense called at the right time. And Brady, you know, just as calmly, as cool as you can, moves out of the pocket and throws it at the feet. Doesn't shake his head, nothing. Just walks back to the huddle and calls the next play. I mean, that guy, he's got such poise and confidence, it doesn't faze him.
He has an amazing ability to respond to pressure. Now, the pressure came that time from LeVar Woods. He's all over the field. He came in a blitz that time. Third and 10. A lot of time. Patrick pass. Turns it up. He's short. Pass will be 2 yards short of the first down as he advances the ball to the 37. See what Belichick elect to do now as his kicker will be going into a gusting wind.
I think they're going to let it get to the 2-minute warning at least. Yeah, that's what they're going to do. Let it get down to the 2-minute warning. Smart play by Bill Belichick, and then they'll run their punt team out.
So the 2-minute warning is given. The Patriots continue to lead the game 14-6. Patriots with the ball, 2 minutes to play. They have fourth down coming up. Brady spreads the field. Too long for a field goal try into a gusting wind. They think they can convert. And why shouldn't they think it? Blitzer, throw, catch. And a penalty marker's fired in. False start is signaled against New England. A pre-snap foul.
Yeah, that'll do it. And then they'll bring this punt team out now.
False start. Offense, number 70. 5-yard penalty remains fourth down.
And a penalty like that, we talk so much, and this is one of the reasons the Patriots are good, is they usually don't do this. And you talk about discipline on a football team, that's where it shows up. Forget about wearing ties on game day. Discipline is not jumping off sides on a fourth down and short play.
So that brings out Josh Miller, and he'll punt. And still 2 minutes to play in the first half. But so far in the game, other than the two Patriot turnovers, the Cardinals have had no downfield offense. Not any in the passing game. Fair catch is signaled for. Next Sunday, the NFL and CBS rolls out regional action featuring David Carr and the Texans going against Priest Holmes and the Chiefs. Meanwhile, the Browns battle the Giants, or the Chargers take on the Broncos. Check local listings beginning with Greg, Dan, Shannon, and Boomer on the NFL Today.
You talked about, you know, penalties that sometimes mean one thing and not another. The Patriots had that first down picked up, and the illegal procedure penalty made them punt the football away. So it goes from being maybe 3 points, maybe a touchdown for the Patriots, to giving the Cardinals a chance to score in the two-minute drill before halftime. One little penalty can have a huge effect.
Another turnover can have a huge effect. We'll see if McCown can get his team downfield protecting the ball. That time he throws for a 10-yard gain. As Lon Pfeiffer come in on the play, Carl Williams makes the catch. The two-minute offense, McCown is from Sam Houston State. Third year, he was a third-round draft choice. Now he stands in on the run. His brother is a backup quarterback with the Browns, and he throws it away, stopping the clock. 1:23 to go in the half. McGinnis putting pressure on.
You know, sometimes you think you've seen the Cardinals struggle offensively, and Dennis Green knows. I mean, he's over there with his hands on his hips, and what they're thinking is, you know, sometimes in 2 minutes, something like this could snap your offense out of it. You see something you like, and all of a sudden they get into a rhythm and they have a little success before halftime, and it'll be enough to give them some motivation and some things to look at in the second half that they can take advantage of. Sometimes a two-minute drill is like changing pitchers in a baseball game.
Well, McCown, it has to be very wary because the Patriots have been in position to defend his downfield throws. He is a nervous guy. They come now with man coverage. Here comes the rush. Down stands in. Fires near side. Makes a connection for a first down to the 37-yard line. Crossfield throw to Bryant Johnson, who was a number one pick out of Penn State last year.
The Patriots just rushing three guys. They dropped everybody else into coverage. And you can bet you'll probably get something different here.
Time a factor, as you see, winding down, 52 seconds. McCown throws a crossing pattern. His tight end, Fred Jones, comes up with the ball.
And there you have it, Don. They brought six guys on McCown that time after bringing three just the play before. And now the Cardinals will take a quick timeout.
And McCown, Steve, starting to get into a little bit of a rhythm. That's the final timeout of the half for the Cardinals. Coming up on the Nextel Halftime Report, join Greg, Dan, Shannon, and Boomer for all the latest scores and highlights. That's all coming up on the Nextel Halftime Report. Don Cricky with Steve Tasker, Sun Devil Stadium, Tempe, Arizona. And young Josh McCown trying to get something going now with time working against him. See, 46 seconds to play in the half.
Already hit two 50-yard plus field goals, so they don't have as far to go as they might think.
Something's going long to Larry Fitzgerald soon. If he can set his feet, he's got an open track to run. Across the 50. Ooh, oh, that's going to be a late hit. Harrison gets him just as he crossed the boundary line. 12-yard gain on the run. There'll be 15 more on top of that.
Yeah,
it'll get you in field goal range.
It may get you a fine, too, even though he went low.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, late hit out of bounds, defense number 37. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Yeah, and that's not something you like to see. Rodney Harrison going low on McCown, and that's, you know, Rodney Harrison has a kind of a reputation for being that guy that will go a little bit extra on a play. That was a little bit beyond extra.
No question, Rodney tends to play on the edge, but well, plays very well.
It's a good thing he did that on the Patriots sidelines. He might not have got out of there if it was the Cardinals sidelines.
He's an enforcer. Every receiver is very wary about going over the middle. You meet him, he's a very impressive young guy. We asked him about his play. He said, I play aggressively. That's how I learned to play the game. That's how I play the game. And here is a sack by Vrabel way back at the 45-yard line. That's the fifth sack of the day of McCown.
That's one of the reasons the Patriots are so good. They have guys all over their roster who can come up with a play at a crucial time, and Romeo Crennel and Belichick put him in a position to make those plays.
There's another sack. He gets the ball away, and it's intercepted. It caroms off the hands of receiver Carl Williams. Now there's a, is there a marker down? Yes, there is, at the line of scrimmage.
It's going to be offsides on New England.
McCown's got to be saying to Steve, what about this football business?
Yeah.
Is this the best business?
By far. Particularly when you're sitting up here. I don't know how you feel about
it. You've been down there in this league.
This is better up here than it is down there.
It's just amazing to watch this Patriot
offside
defense unfold.
Defense, number 93, in the neutral zone at the snap. 5-yard penalty. Repeat, second down.
And there's no missing it. It's right here. He goes with the football when it goes. And you see, he just got out of there a little early, and that's why he's in McCown's lap.
Might be the best defensive lineman in the NFL, Richard Seymour. One the scouting service has him rated in the top five players in the NFL at any position. That's high.
And here's a nice little try here. We had two already from over 50. Here's a 58-yard field goal.
This guy's going for bonus today.
Are you kidding me? Well, he hasn't had enough to hit it from 58.
Well, his career long is 54. So Rackers has been the one shining light from a production standpoint on the offensive side with two field goals of over 50 yards.
I don't disagree with him trying it, but I'll tell you what, right now, Don, Neil Rackers is not going to hit this kick. 58 yards. You need a gun.
You've seen the future, and you don't think he's going to make it. There he is trying a 58-yarder earlier today. Did that go over?
That way, that made it. Let me tell you something. He's not kicking the same football now that he was kicking in warmups. The ball that they kick in the NFL is fresh out of the box. It's like kicking
hard as a rock.
It is a rock. That's why it's so difficult to hit these long field goals.
They used to kick those used balls that were rounded like a rugby ball.
He makes this, it's the kick of the year. Until Adam Vinatieri kicks one in the Super Bowl again.
Now we have a delay, and let's see what Tony Corrente says.
Patriots took a timeout to ice the kicker, just in case. Did they take a timeout?
Tell you, Racker seems like a happy guy out there getting these long chances.
As a kicker, I've heard these guys say it. All you do is you kick this ball before, kick it again. Don't worry about the pressure of the situation. Just kick it. Blocked.
Yeah, they got a piece of it. Skips into the end zone. And with just 4 seconds left to play, the ball turns over to New England. Of course, in a long miss like that, you get the ball at the spot.
That's going to be at the 48-yard line.
So Rackers, good from 51, good from 52, partially blocked from 58.
And he had to kick that so low to get it there. He had to drive the ball to get all the distance he could out of it, and it was just a little too low coming out.
One thing the Cardinals have been good at, Steve, they forced 3 turnovers against the Rams last week. Didn't get any points off them. They forced 2 turnovers against the Patriots today.
Well, that's one factor, you're right, Don, that makes your team better in an exponential way. If you can get turnovers, you can be a bad football team and look pretty darn good.
I can tell you're a Northwestern graduate. Exponential.
That's cold.
Oh, that's... And that'll do it for the first half of play. As the first half, after the Patriots took a 14-0 lead on 2 Tom Brady touchdown passes to his tight end, Daniel Graham. Now the Cardinals come back a bit and trail 14-6. We'll be back with the Nextel halftime report after this message and a word from your local station. Oh, they're putting a second back on the clock. Don't go away.
Well, they're sticklers for accuracy in the NFL. And they're going to bring everybody back out.
Every moment counts. There's Charlie Weiss, the standout offensive coordinator of the Patriots. So in the first half, the running game of the Cardinals was pretty limited by Emmitt Smith. He got 21 yards on 8 carries. McCown on three scrambles got 19 yards, but the base running game of the Cardinals has been shut down. Just as Rodney Harrison told us it would be, said they're not going to run. It won't happen.
Now the Patriots have time for a Hail Mary if they'd like to take it. It looks like they're in the formation. Tom Brady may roll to the near side to get this ball off.
Well, he won the long distance passing title in the NFL quarterback challenge. He does get it to the end zone.
Caught. Intercepted.
Intercepted in the game. Halftime is not over as the interceptor now running it back. That's James Darling. He ran one back 95 yards last week, but it was called back. And they're ruling the ball is down.
And there was a penalty after the turnover for a block in the back by a Cardinals player.
Yeah, you got a Patriot down. Trainer running over quickly. Looks like
Branch.
It might be Branch is down. Deion
after
Branch.
The interception and during the return, illegal block in the back, defense number 97. By rule, the half is over.
And here's the play as they're going to try and tip it. And that right there, of course, is David Givens trying to tip it. And there's the carom that goes into Darling's hands. And you'll see the block right there as it comes into your screen.
Oh, man.
Oh, and there's a
chopped him ankle high.
Yeah, that's also illegal.
That's the end of the first half with the Patriots leading 14-6. We'll be back with the Nextel halftime report after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Back at the Valley of the Sun, it's the halftime score. New England 14, Arizona 10. The NFL on CBS will continue after this word from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS. Day when the NFL honors the late Pat Tillman, the former Arizona Cardinals standout, who died as Army Ranger in Afghanistan. His mom unfurled a field-sized flag before the games. Moments ago, Pat's wife, Marie, spoke.
Thank all of his fans and the people of Arizona for all the support that they gave him throughout the years. I also want to thank all of you for the continued support that you've given me and the family during this very difficult time. It really helps us knowing that his spirit and his memory live on in all of you. Thank you.
Pat Tillman, as I'm sure you're aware, was killed in the line of duty last April while serving as an Army Ranger in Afghanistan. Shortly after his death, the Cardinals announced that it was retiring Pat's jersey number 40 and that the perimeter area surrounding the new Cardinals Stadium, scheduled to open in 2006, would be known as the Pat Tillman Freedom Plaza. There's his dad, Pat, one of the 1.4 million Americans, men and women, in uniform military service. There are another 1.3 million in reserves, and everyone, all 2.7 million, are like Pat Tillman volunteers. At the half, the score is the Patriots 14 and the Cardinals 6. Don Cricky with Steve Tasker. An interesting day in the Valley of the Sun. It looked like it was going to be a blowout as the Patriots jumped out to a 14-0 lead on two Brady touchdown passes to Daniel Graham. And then a couple of unlikely turnovers got the Cardinals back in it.
That's really what has kept the Cardinals in this game, plus a couple of long field goals from Neil Rackers, which were sensational, 51 and 53 yards. The Cardinals have not given up on this, and you're right, Don, it did look like it was going to get out of hand in a hurry, but the Cardinals have battled back. Dennis Green is trying to turn this culture around. They have yet to play better on defense, and they've got to do better if they're going to win this football game. Offensively, they've done nothing.
Well, the Cardinals have to get the ball downfield more. Their young quarterback, Josh McCown, is absolutely perplexed by this changing Patriot defense, which gets every quarterback, let alone a guy only starting his fifth NFL game.
They've gotten two interceptions from Brady, and that in and of itself is a small victory for this Cardinal defense. They're going to have to do more to get pressure on him to make sure that he doesn't have a big day against them. And this, Corey Dillon has been the difference in this game.
Well, the Patriot defenders said that they would not run against us. And in the first half, the Cardinals have only 40 yards rushing after the Colts in that opening game at Gillette Stadium had 202 yards.
And there you see the difference in the statistics, that the Patriots really doing anything they want offensively as long as they don't get turnovers. They also have five sacks against Josh McCown. That's got to change if the Cardinals want to do anything offensively in the second half as well. But Emmitt Smith has been kept in check, and turnovers are going to continue to be a factor in this game.
Well, turnovers have loomed large in this game. The Patriots, uncharacteristically, have turned the ball over twice in the first half. And the Cardinals are pretty good at that. They forced three turnovers at St. Louis, didn't get any points off them. Today they got the two field goals off them. So we're not done. Patriots are in a fight.
And when the Cardinals have had success, it is because they have been in Tom Brady's lap. If they can pressure him in some way, shape, or form, that's when they've had their chance to make big plays. But you can bet Bill Belichick on the sideline and in the locker room at halftime made some adjustments, and they're going to get something they didn't see in the first half, and they're going to get a lot of it here in the second.
There's McCown on the phone, getting all the help he can, and who wouldn't need it against these guys? They just keep unfurling it. Dennis Green summed it up best, Steve. You played for him at Northwestern. He said that the Belichick's defenses show you things you're not expecting, and then they continue to change quarter after quarter and continue to show you new things. And when you're a young quarterback, sometimes it can be overwhelming.
And it's a tribute to the guys he keeps on his roster, Don. If you look down the roster, the reason a lot of these guys are on Bill Belichick's team is because they can do a lot of different things. They've got linebackers who can cover. They've got linebackers who can rush the passer. And a lot of times they're the same guy. They've got defensive backs who can cover. They can blitz. They can do a lot of different things. It gives them a versatility on the defensive side of the ball that a lot of teams just can't match.
Now the kickoff. Ball is drilled by Rackers. And this guy can kick a football. 10 yards deep and out of the end zone, so Bethel can go nowhere with it. And it'll come out to the 20.
At the end of the first half, this is what happened. It was a Hail Mary to try and get to the end zone. It was picked off on the tip by Darling. And watch. Right here, there's a block in the back right here as it comes in. Right there, watch Branch goes right down and gets taken out. That's illegal as well. It's illegal to block below the waist, let alone low like that. We don't know how Deion Branch is. He got up.
Oh, he got chopped ankle high.
And that is illegal to block below the waist. It was not called.
Ankle high. Dillon goes right at the Cardinals, and not for very much as he's dropped at the 21-yard line. Burt Berry makes another stop. Dillon in the first half with 16 carries for 81 yards.
And this first series of the second half is always an important one because it gives your coaching staff a chance to reevaluate and get in their players' ears and say, listen, they're hurting us with this, this, and this. We can stop it if we do this, this, and this. Halftime of an NFL locker at an NFL locker room is a classroom. It is not a yelling match.
The adjustments are made. The Patriots, as good as there is at making halftime adjustments, Brady gets time and throws a ball. It's caught and lost. That's a fumble out with there. Waving it off is incomplete. There might be a red flag coming out here.
Now, Dwayne Starks was on the coverage, had excellent coverage, broke on the ball and knocked it away. Never had total possession. You'll watch here. And that's a good call. David Givens just never had total control of that football. Once it hits the ground, the play is over. No way you review that.
Well, apparently, they're ruling it, agreeing with him out of the Cardinals that there was no turnover on the play. It wasn't an incomplete pass. And that brings up third down and 9. Four wideouts. Brady, so good at standing in, lost a long ball, and it is caught by David Givens. A sensational third down catch by David Givens at the 48-yard line. A 28-yard gain on the play.
Everything was going the way of the Cardinals. They had him in 3rd and 8, right where you want him to be. And watch as Givens makes an inside move, goes right up the seam, and you cannot throw it better than that.
How about the catch?
Wow.
Givens, a 7th-round draft choice out of Notre Dame, was a long shot to make the team 3 years ago. He stood in front of that ball machine that can gun balls at you 80 miles an hour. It used to catch 100 a day through the offseason. He came back and caught everything, made the team starting, and now Patton breaks away. Patton working the sideline, goes out of bounds, and the Patriots start to move on this opening drive of the third quarter. Quentin Harris gets him out of bounds.
It's a shame it's not flag football. You'll watch as he catches this ball right at the line of scrimmage. And that's Macklin, who pulls his flag but doesn't pull him down.
The flag will not get you down.
Yeah, the flag is
not decoy.
It's not two-hand touch here. And there's a sign of the heat rise. David Patton gets massaged. You can get cramps, you get pulled muscles. It all comes to the forefront in a heated day like this.
Corey Dillon, they're reading his number now, Steve, with the gaps that were open for the cutbacks by Dillon aren't there right now. James Darling and Carlos Dansby on the stop.
That's job number one for the coaches up in the booth, up here where we're sitting, up here in the press box. They have a group of coaches who watch that. They will get keys and relay them to their players in the second half. Say, listen, we can stop their running game because they'll give them formation tips. They'll give them other tips that the players can use. And more often than not, most defensive teams in the NFL will do much better against the run in the second half because of the coaches upstairs.
Pitch back. Dillon. Room to go. Corey Dillon gets it down close to the 27-yard line. And that'll bring up third and about a yard, a six-yard gain, another tackle by the former Eagle, James Darling, 51.
And watch here as Corey Dillon comes in, he'll tuck this ball away. And you'll see there's one guy he shrugs off, another guy he pulls out of, and he almost tuts it to the sideline. You just can't get him down unless you're right in front of him. If he gets parallel with you and you reach out to grab him, he'll either drag you for 7 yards or he'll break right through your grip. You've got to put a body in front of him to stop it, not an arm.
He's a rare combination, Corey Dillon, of speed and power. He'll pound a defense. We've talked to him about he loves to run off the tackles. He does not like to go wide. He said, I'll do it if that's where the run is. That's where the gap is. But he is a tackle-to-tackle runner, a slasher.
Well, you and I saw him rush for 278 yards against the number two rush defense that year in the Denver Broncos. He rushed for 278 yards on 22 carries that day. That gives you an idea of what this guy can do. He can outrun people.
Yeah, he's outrushed Arizona. First down. Dillon. Not done, but he's inside the 15-yard line and down to the 11. The big play in this drive. On third and nine, Brady hit a long downfield throw, a jumping reception by David Givens for a 28-yard game. And now as Dillon goes over 100 yards rushing for the day, the Patriots are looking to go into the end zone.
You saw there as he came out of the backfield, got tripped up at the line of scrimmage, and put his hand down to catch himself and got the extra yard. That's a guy that's got some ability. I mean, he got tripped up and kept his balance for an extra 8 yards.
This time they go to Patrick Pass, who works the middle of the field. Of course, in the two touchdowns that were scored in the first half, it was down in this area that Tom Brady stood in and waited, and his young tight end Daniel Graham came open, and he got him twice for touchdowns on short throws.
And with that last run, Corey Dillon went over 100 yards for the 29th time in his career.
Now it is second and four from the 5-yard line. Second and five for a touchdown. Pass. Stopped at the two. Very close to a first down, though, as the linesman comes in to mark it.
I don't think he's going to get the first down, but you can see how effective the Patriots are in the running game. As Pass comes in and just puts his head down, and that's what you want to do, Don. Don't run side to side. If you're going to get tackled, deliver the blow in the red zone.
Dillon's back in, and we should also note that a couple of guys are going to come in, and Mike Vrabel has come in, and I think he's announcing that he is eligible.
Let me tell you something. Mike Vrabel's the guy who's caught a touchdown in the Super Bowl. He's one of those versatile athletes we were talking about. He's a linebacker. He's going to play tight end. And that much left for the first down. Done it. You see Corey Dillon come into the game. If I'm the Arizona Cardinals, I know Corey Dillon is going to get the football. But by the same token, I've got the trickiest coach in the league on the other side. He always does the unexpected. But I got to give Corey Dillon this football.
As Dennis Green told us, Steve, he said, you know what you're going to see is something you haven't seen before on both sides of the ball from the Patriots. So now they're in an advantageous position with two downs to hammer it, either for a first down or a touchdown. Go to a power package, extra tight ends, eye set. That Dan Klecko in is the up back, 90 to block. They follow Klecko. Gillen goes in. Out of where there's a marker is down.
It's going to be an illegal shift on the Patriots.
Done on that touchdown, it's not going to count.
Illegal motion, offense, number 88 was moving forward at the snap. 5-yard penalty, repeat, third down.
That touchdown, even though it didn't count, that is good football. You've got guys that you depend on. Give it to the big back, and this is Christian Fourier moves toward the line of scrimmage at the end. I don't know, you can't see it from that angle. I didn't see it when the ball was snapped. That's a lot of push to get stopped. Watch the offensive line of the Patriots just go sideways, and they finally get some edge and just push them into the end zone. That's good football.
There is Fourier. Now it is third down. Look for a lot of crossing patterns run by the Patriot receivers. Pump fake. Brady looks. Penalty marker goes down as he's sacked. Burt Berry makes the play. Second sack today of Tom Brady.
Brady wanted to do the pump fake and then throw it to the corner of the end zone. The defender played it perfectly out on Christian Fourier. And then Brady ran out of time.
Holding offense number 72. His penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Matt Light, the left tackle. Here's the sack coming right up here. And Brady has to come off his first receiver, and you see his eyes go back to the left, and it's just too late.
Berry, a tough guy to hold out, and he made it as a free agent. Was with the Colts for a while, then with Denver, really blossomed. Came here as a free agent. Now a 29-yard field goal for Adam Vinatieri.
Had to switch the kicking ball in, as you see the officials had the wrong football on the field.
Kicking ball, as you mentioned, Steve, being a new ball, hard as a rock. Automatic for Adam, and the Patriots extend their lead now to 17-6 on the field goal. We'll be coming back with the Patriots kicking off in a moment. Tom Brady, a hot afternoon in the Valley of the Sun, overcast now. We've been waiting for rain. It rained pretty hard here last night as Hurricane Javier is off the coast of Mexico and moving up. It's only rained 3 inches here in the last year. What an unbelievable four-year drought. Now the kickoff, and Scobie can't bring it out. So well hit by Vinatieri. Cardinals start from their 20. The Patriots have won 24 straight games when leading at the half. They led at the half today, 14-6.
NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of Super Bowl 39. Nextel. Nextel helps groups get things done. Nextel. Done. And by Dodge. You can take life as it comes, or you can grab life by the horns. Dodge.
Go Cardinals!
Cardinals have the ball, down 17-6 after the 29-yard field goal by Adam Vinatieri. And then a kickoff by Vinatieri that couldn't be returned. McCown to Emmitt Smith. Looking for a gap. None to be found. Ted Johnson stops him. They're high above the stadium. You get people up on the hill there in the Bob Uecker seats.
Glad that you could get your family tickets there, Don. It's very nice of you.
You got all of them in the stadium for your teammates from Dodge. Junior College, Dodge City.
Yes, the Conks are here in force today.
Fabulous Conquistadors. Second down and 8. McCown, good play fake, rolls out, buys some time, makes a throw in traffic, and what a connection, and they're not done. On the run is the big guy, the tight end, Fred Jones, who's a terrific target. 27-yard gain. He had to thread that in. I mean, the Patriot coverage looked to be excellent.
There's no question. This is the best play action fake that McCown's made all day. And Freddie Jones smartly just keeps his feet. Rodney Harrison goes for a big hit, doesn't wrap up, and then ends up cleaning up on a tackle further down the field. Freddie Jones, a veteran guy, has been around a long time. He played with Rodney Harrison in San Diego, so he knows if you can keep your feet sometimes, the DBs won't wrap up and you can get some extra yards.
Yeah, he's strong and quick, tough to jam at the line of scrimmage. Jones can get downfield like he did there. Emmitt Smith showing his Hall of Fame style as he works the ball inside the 45-yard line.
This is one of the things, this is what the Cardinals are up against. You got a team in New England who has 16 games going back to last year since they've lost a game. And that's what you're up against in a, at home in your home opener. It never gets easy in the NFL, but you got a team that's going against history right there. You look at the top, back in the 30s and 40s, teams used to go 18 straight. It's been that long since teams have been able to do it like the Patriots are getting it done.
Patriots digging in now as the Cardinal defense with the young quarterback showing a little bit more confidence and playmaking ability. Another throw, out pattern, good open field shot put on. Ty Law makes the stop. A gain of only a yard. It'll be a third down and three. Ty Law likes that. Everybody likes that on the Patriots side.
Yeah, they, you know, these Patriots, we talked about their winning streak and all of that. It's not like they're blowing people out. 9 of the 16 straight wins have been by a touchdown or less. They've had a couple of overtime victories sprinkled in there. This is a club that knows how to win and knows how to close the deal. And that's why Arizona, when they come into this football game, that's where the Cardinals want to be. They got into a dogfight last week in St. Louis and came up on the short end of the stick. And this is a nice measuring stick for how far they have to come. This is one of the best clubs in the NFL.
Not the Cardinals, the Patriots.
The Patriots.
I would say that. Here is McCown standing in on third down. He's in trouble. Penalty marker's thrown. Patriot pass rush, he might have been tackled as McCown displays good running ability and gets down to the 35. But it looks like it's going to go against Arizona. Tony Corretti says bring it all back.
Yeah, the flag came out very early. McCown felt the pressure, and so did the offensive lineman who grabbed onto Mike Vrabel and just pulled him to the foot to the ground. That was Leonard Davis, I believe.
Huge contingent of Patriot fans here.
Holding, offense number 75, 10-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Leonard Davis, who was the third player picked in the draft when he came out of the University of Texas 3 years ago.
You watch there working against Faber. Watch, he just pulls him to the ground, and you know, he pulls him to the ground, then jumps on. And believe me, when 380 jumps on you, your play is done. You're going to take it off till the next play, the next snap.
Talk about those Patriot fans, though, Steve. Bob Kraft came in, the owner of the Patriots. He said a woman, 91 years old, who used to live in New England, couldn't get tickets, came out here. She wrote to him, got her tickets. I think she's sitting with the Krafts. But there's as much blue in the stands as there is red today. Patriot fans in abundance. As here's a good throw as the ball's triggered to Brian Johnson, and he runs it down to the 42-yard line. He's less than a yard from a first down, a 12-yard gain on the play. You got to go.
You know, this is something that the Cardinals look more crisp here in the second half, and McCown looks more crisp. And the reason is he's getting the football out of his hands faster. He's not staring down his receivers. He doesn't have a chance to go to a second and third. He's getting rid of the ball right away, and he's not giving the New England defense a chance to get in his lap. Good play calls by the Cardinals. Get the ball out of his hands.
By the nose of the ball, the Cardinals get the first down. So Bill Belichick knows that his team is in the game. He told us, he said, you know, we have nothing to go on this team. We don't play them. We don't know much about them. He said it's kind of a learning experience to get out there against them.
And that's one of the things I don't think Bill Belichick likes. I mean, this is a guy who is a film junkie. I mean, he studies players. He studies coaches. He knows how to get into the mindset of his opponent's coaching staff and come up with a plan to beat him. But if you don't see him on film, you can't get into that mindset. And I think he feels at a disadvantage this week.
There's a handoff. Driving run by Emmitt Smith. Not very much. A marker is down. Linesman threw it at the far side of the field. Ty Warren is on the stop for the Patriots. Patriots with 16 straight wins, 24 straight wins if they let it half as they did today, 28 straight wins after leading after three quarters.
Illegal motion offense, number 85, was going forward at the snap. 5-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
Well, you can't say they're not calling it both ways.
You played for Denny Green. What was he like as a coach?
Oh, very conscientious. This is a guy that knows how to motivate people. This is a guy, Dennis Green, who will get the most out of his players. He has, I think, the gift that Denny Green brings to his team is the fact that he can watch guys play in practice and on film and say, I know I can win with him or I cannot win with him. Plus, he says he knows what their strengths are, and he can let his players play to their own strengths.
Good pound running from McGinnis. He dumps the ball up. It's caught by Jones. A hobble catch. Was he inbounds?
Yes, he was. But I think that's what Dennis Green does best.
4-yard gain.
And you talk to any coach in the NFL, and what they want to do is give their guys a chance to win. You hear it all the time. What is also goes hand in hand with that is their ability to say, you know, this is what our team does best.
What's this now? This is the Northwestern Wildcats. And
big, strong guy standing over there.
Number 6 in your program.
And there's
number 1 in your heart. Number 4 on your depth chart, Steve Tasker.
That's me.
And his coach, Dennis Green.
He knows how far I was sitting away from him in the team picture.
Second down. Here is McCown. Boy, the heat's always on. Man alive. He throws into traffic and very nearly picked. He's trying to get the ball to Fitzgerald, that great young rookie receiver. And he's forcing it at him, and the Patriots have a double on Fitzgerald because they know that's where he's going. He caught 4 last week, Larry Fitzgerald. And everyone was for a first down against the Rams. A terrific kid. I mean, he's what they call him, late night Larry, not because he's hanging around clubs around town, because he never leaves the complex. He's always in here watching film.
Yeah, they keep him, they kick him out, literally. I mean, he's there all the time. And on that, McCown trying to give him a chance to make a play, but that was a bad decision on McCown, and he got lucky that that was incomplete.
Well, he's going there again before long to Fitzgerald, because Fitzgerald can go up and get the jump balls. Tremendous hands. And another pre-snap foul is a penalty marker. Roosevelt Colvin in there with some words from McCown. Great to see Roosevelt back after undergoing a hip surgery a year ago.
Can't start. Offense. Number 75, 5-yard penalty will remain third down.
Leonard Davis, who a little while ago was called for holding, now is called for moving early. And you see there, it's obvious. The Patriots saw it too, giving the officials a little help. And that brings up third and a long way. And this is something the Cardinals have got to overcome. And that's, you know, it's your own mistakes that put you back in third and long. And Dennis Green knows. I mean, this is what he's fighting in his own team. The ability to keep from hurting themselves.
Cutting back, he's inside the 10, the 5, and he dives! And Willie's out. Out of bounds at the 5. But the Cardinals hit the Patriots with a big play. Two-yard gain on the play.
Finally, the offensive line makes a crease, and Josh Scobie finds it. Just a little screen pass here. This is because of the pressure that the Patriots have been applying on McCown. They run the screen pass to take the starch out of it. They know they've been getting pressure. The Patriots are trying to get in the backfield. They let him go and throw it right behind him.
After making a play like that, they've got to try to get it in. Here's McCown taking a look. He's got an open man, but that's he can't see him. Now he fires, and it's incomplete.
And once again, you just saw the screen pass. Because of the pressure that McCown's been getting, the Cardinals finally call a screen pass to make the defensive lineman use their aggression against them. And it worked to perfection. And then on this play, watch this.
Brian Johnson
running by himself, Ty Law watching him, and then he steps out of bounds. As soon as he steps out of bounds, he's ineligible. So he couldn't even have come back in bounds to catch that pass had it been directed at him.
Second and goal. Emmitt Smith, nothing.
Now it's third and goal, and it's all on the quarterback to make something happen.
The New England Patriots defense has the innate ability to find the point of attack of a running play and shut it off immediately. Even if they don't have enough guys over there, what they do is they diagnose the running play, they get their guys to stop it, and it makes the running back have to pick someplace else to run. And usually it's right into the pursuit of their defense. Romeo Crennel, great defensive play calling. And his defense is diagnosing this running game expertly.
Red zone defense was a problem at times last year for the Patriots. It's been stout today. McCown fires. Nothing. Yeah, that's penalty marker. The first and goal at the one.
Ty Law was all over the back of Bryant Johnson. You can see it coming. It's in the end zone. It's going to be first and goal on the one for the Cards.
Pass interference, defense, number 24. As a foul occurred in the end zone, the ball will be spotted at the 1 yard line. First down.
You see it right at the top of your screen, right up there. Watch, he's right all over his back. Put, oh, yeah. You can't do that with your body, even though you're looking for the ball. Johnson had perfect position on the pass, and there's nothing that Ty Law could do about it.
Well, they're setting up for a hammer and anvil offense. Big blocking back in front of Emmitt Smith. They're going that way. Here's Emmitt going wide, cutting back. He's in. Cardinals back in it with a long way to go. Emmitt Smith, as he has done countless times before, drives it in with low power. He's hard to get a shot on.
Well, he's always had this ability. When he's down close, nobody can pick a spot to get in the end zone like Emmitt Smith. That's the 157th touchdown of his career. And believe me, he earned every one of them.
So he did. He has two this year, one last week against the Rams. Now down by five, and rather than make it a four-point margin, they're going to go for two. Try to get to the field goal. Still in the third quarter. Play fake. McCown has it. Not for long. Now he looks. Good feet. Can count the house in this play. Goes to the end zone. Incomplete. He sure had time to look. He checked down everybody.
Yeah, and unfortunately, that's the most poise that McCown has shown all day.
But then the throw was errant, and Rodney Harrison stepped in and got a finger on the ball, tipped it away. Back to the Valley of the Sun, Emmitt Smith with his 157th career touchdown. And it's the Cardinals back in the game. Their two-point conversion try, no good. They've not gotten a touchdown throw from their quarterback either in four preseason games or now into the second regular season game this year. But they're in the game, and here is a hard kick by Rackers, caroming into the end zone and out of it for a touchback. Brady and the Patriots will start at their 20. Heat's a factor, unusual humidity. Temperature on the field has been about 100.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by IBM, making on-demand business a reality for companies around the world. And by Chrysler, inspiration comes standard.
The heat factor is certainly coming into play now. The Patriots. And this is an unseasonably mild day. Its temperature now on the field is 90, but it is unusually humid. Usually the humidity is in single digits. Today it's in the high 60s because of Hurricane Javier. A light rain has begun to fall. And here's Brady lofting a long ball and hits David Givens. Wayne Starks, who's been a Pro Bowl cornerback, covering, and Givens beats him for a 21-yard gain.
And this is another one of those times. David Givens, who is the big receiver for New England, he's 6 foot tall. and working against Starks, and this is a difficult route to defend because he's got so much room over there. Starks doesn't know whether he's going to stop, and Ducati's got to play that very conservatively because he doesn't have anybody behind him in case Given stops. He's got to play that so difficult. It's difficult to defend that kind of route.
Difficult to defend Corey Dillon as he can't wait to hit somebody running the ball. He runs it for 10 yards before a big safety, Adrian Wilson, gets him down.
You know, we saw how the New England Patriots were kind of running away with this, and now the Cardinals are back in it, and this is the reason. I mean, they're pretty tough at home, 4-4. They were 0-8 on the road with a 23-point margin, but they beat a lot of pretty good football teams. Green Bay Packers, a playoff team. Minnesota, they kept them out of the playoffs on the final play from scrimmage last year, kept the Vikings out of the playoffs. They're tough at home.
Yeah, McCown threw a touchdown pass. Run, not much going on. Dillon stopped by LeVar Woods, a terrific linebacker, number 56 for Arizona. Dillon has now run the ball 21 times for 113 yards. As the third quarter is winding down and out. That's the end of the third quarter with a score. New England 17 and Arizona 12 will return to Sun Devil Stadium after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS. We're back at Sun Devil Stadium. Brady drops to throw on second down. Over the middle throw, it's David Givens with the ball for a first down as he takes it to the 31-yard line, a 19-yard gain. So Givens now becoming a primary target on these patterns. He's caught 4 for 81 yards today.
And New England continues to grind out the yards offensively. David Givens catching the crossing route, a sensational route. It took a lot of time, and Brady had the time to wait on it to come open.
Brady building his numbers, 12 completions and 22 throws, 2 touchdowns, but he's been intercepted twice. And again, on a quick hitch, they get the ball to Givens, and Givens, a strong back from Humble, Texas. And Notre Dame takes the ball ahead for 12 yards and another first down.
And they've done that all day, and the reason they can do it is the Cardinals are not challenging the receivers on the outside. You've got Givens, Patton, Branch all out there by themselves with a 10-yard cushion, and Brady steps back, doesn't even drop, just flings it out there. And all of these receivers are quick enough to make one guy miss, and it turns into an 11 or 12-yard gain.
Hits back. Here's Dillon. Gets a gap into the outside, and Dillon runs the ball inside the 15-yard line. Corey Dillon played only 1 year at the University of Washington, came out of junior college to the Huskies, and he broke every Washington rushing record in that 1 year, then came to the NFL after his junior year at Washington.
And this right here, what a sensational block by Hochstein. He comes out, blocks two guys to the ground, and Dillon is able to get to the outside. This offensive line for the New England Patriots looks as fresh as it did in the first quarter.
Yeah, a tribute to their conditioning. A hot, humid day in Arizona. Back to Dillon, pounding away and protecting the ball. He's down close to the 10-yard line. Darnell Dockett gets him down, and the Patriots, I think, Steve, looking to run clock as they run the ball.
Corey Dillon is slow getting up, and they're calling for the trainers to come in. He stayed down after that run. What happens sometimes, Don, you get caught under the pile, and it's, you know, nothing other than getting put in a bad spot and guys falling on top of you. What happens sometimes, you'll fall on the football and you get the wind knocked out of you by the football itself. As you can see, he tried to get up, and the trainers always say, no, stay down. Because if particularly if there's nothing wrong with him, they'll say stay down because all our guys need a rest.
Yeah. Hopefully, Corey will be bouncing up when we come back in a moment. Good report on Corey Dillon. He bounced up and tried to run back to the huddle. He had to go out for at least a play, so he ran off the field. So he's all right. I think he was winded like you speculated, Steven. In his absence, the Patriots go to the run, and not much happening there. On third down and short, it stopped. Patrick pass. Russell Davis, Carlos Dansby, both on the stop.
You see there, Patrick Pass is trying to keep cramping up, stretching his legs out.
And that's going to be a problem. You watch, is you have to keep an eye on that. Guys go down, they begin to do stretching exercises because their body starts to tighten up and almost the point where you can't even run off the football field.
Once you really tighten up, it's awful hard to keep going
back. It's over. You know, you almost can't play anymore when you start cramping up.
28-yard field goal by Vinatieri, which, if good, would extend to an 8-point lead for the Patriots. Vinatieri is good again. Patriots build a 20-12 lead, and Adam Vinatieri will be kicking off when we come back to the Valley of the Sun. New England leading 20-12. Corey Dillon being administered to, looks like he's working on a muscle, trapezius muscle in the back of his neck, shoulder. Vinatieri kicks off. High spinning kick. Scobie will bring it back at the Patriots. 15. The gap. Heads out to the 25-yard line. Is he down?
Yes, he was down back at the 27.
Kept going. Tonight on 60 Minutes, Bill Belichick and John Fox got their teams to the Super Bowl. How did they do it? Don't miss 60 Minutes tonight.
Well, we got a good look at how Bill Belichick got his team to the Super Bowl in this game here. And a good offense, a solid running game, and doing the unexpected on the field and executing it exactly the way you draw it up.
Patriots led by as many as 14-0 in a point count early in the game. It was 14-6 at half. Now it's 20-12. Cardinals looking for a touchdown, a hard thrown ball to Larry Fitzgerald, the sure-handed one from Pittsburgh. Number 3 pick in the whole draft. We asked him what's the hardest part of being a rookie. He said the amount of time you have. There's no classes to go to, no homework to do.
Yeah, you don't hear many guys complaining that they don't have homework. And this is where he used to be. There he is. 1995, and he's a ball boy. He's not a player. And, of course, Dennis Green knows him well enough to say, you know what, he's worth the third pick of the draft.
Larry's dad is a sports writer in the Twin Cities and a close friend of Dennis Green. Here it turns out that he's now playing for Dennis Green. And here's Emmitt Smith getting nothing on a second down carry, needing a 3. He loses about a half yard as Ty Law and Mike Vrabel come back on the stop.
And once again, it seems like the defense of the Patriots diagnoses it, and everybody comes to the point of attack, forcing Emmitt Smith to bounce it one way or the other. He never gets to the line of scrimmage without making a cut, and that's what the Patriots want. Romeo Crennel in charge of making those calls. Once again, they're successful.
Crennel's defense constantly changing. Look at the look he gets now. Everybody comes up. Looks like a blitz defense on third down and needing 4. Here comes the rush. Throw and a pick. And a penalty marker's down. There is a penalty marker down in the Patriots secondary. We'll see if someone was blocked or held outside the 5-yard area. Wipe out the interception if it's a call against the New England defense. Eugene Wilson made the pick. Boy, is he evolving into a terrific player, this second-year player from Illinois. Starting free safety.
Illegal contact with an eligible receiver. Defense, number 95. 5-yard penalty, automatic. First down.
It's Roman Pfeiffer on the penalty, and that's one of the things that you see more and more of. I mean, it's a point of emphasis. They don't want the receivers to be touched after 5 yards down the line, 5 yards down the field. And you know, it doesn't say, a lot of guys were up in arms about that. They were going to change the game. It was going to make it impossible for defenders to do it. And you talked to all the defensive backs in the league, and they have not noticed a difference in the way the officials call it.
Well, they call it very tight, as you know, Steve, in the preseason. And then in the regular season game, everybody was aware it was going to be called tight. The rule hasn't changed. Here's a long ball. So they pick it off this time. Same guy, Eugene Wilson. And he takes it back to the 48-yard line. So a pick by Wilson, negated by the foul call. First down for the Cardinals. Next play, McCown throws it right to Wilson again.
And that was a bad decision and a bad throw. Fitzgerald double covered once again, and once again McCown tries to force it in.
13-yard return. McCown with his first interception of the day. And the Patriots have it back with an 8-point lead.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by the all-new season of the critically acclaimed series The Wire, only on HBO. Check your local listings. Dr. Pepper and your Dr. Pepper bottler. Be you, nothing's better, Dr. Pepper. And by Best Buy. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours.
We're back, and Tom Brady drops to throw. Beautifully thrown. David Givens is inside the 25-yard line. Yet another Brady to Givens connection. Quentin Harris, strong safety, makes the tackle, but he does it 27 yards downfield.
On the last series, Givens had the two big plays, a 19-yarder and another big one for a first down, and here he gets it going again. He's becoming Brady's favorite receiver. This guy is really having a day against the Cardinals defense. They cannot stop him.
Givens with six catches now for 121 yards. Corey Dillon, Bill Belichick told us he's getting the yards after the tackle, the first hit that we didn't used to get. And he said he's just a tackle breaker, and he gives you extra, what they call yak yards, yards after catch or yards after first hit.
And now you can see the double prong attack. Corey Dillon back in the game. They throw it to Givens. He gets the big gainer, so they start thinking about him. Then they just hand it to the big guy in the backfield, and he gets some yards. The Cardinals are really up against a good football team, and the Patriots, I think, are playing better than they have at any point in the first game or in this game.
One scouting report, Steve, on Givens is he's not super fast, but he finds a way to get behind the defense. And he catches everything, and now they go back to Dillon. Pounding away just like he likes it. 25 carries now for Dillon, 137 yards.
And that's exactly the kind of game they need. You want to have him carry it 25 to 30 times. And there you see it. It's been since 1997. They've had a rusher and a receiver over 100 yards.
Last year, the Patriots were 27th in the NFL in rushing, averaged only 3.4 yards a rush. Still won the Super Bowl. Now Dillon, again, hit from behind, is pushed for plus yards to the 9-yard line. And that'll bring up second down and about 8. Second and 9 for a touchdown. Burt Barry had another tackle. Brady had an interesting observation after the win over the Colts, Steve. They asked him what he thought of the game. He said, you win, you move on. We've got a lot of work to do.
Yeah, you're right. And he's the guy that sets the tone. I mean, the players who play with him think he's the best. He may be the best. They play like he's the best. He acts like he's the best, but he's just one of the guys. I mean, they love this guy in the huddle.
He certainly wins the best. Here's a throw, another connection. And it's down to the 4-yard line. Brady firing the ball in.
And this is something.
Troy Brown.
You know, Don, this is something. This offense now, the New England Patriots, looks better, fresher, sharper than it did in the first quarter. And maybe the drop of 20 degrees on the field has played a bigger factor than we thought, because at this point, most teams who come in here are dragging right about now. They can't even get back to the huddle. The Patriots look like they just began the game.
There's no question. They're fit, ready to go. And here's a guy really ready to go. It's Dillon. Drives it down. There's an interesting call now. Did he get to the first down mark? It appears he did not. It's about a yard short, so it'll be fourth down and 1. What appears where the spot will be. Fourth and 1 for a first down, fourth and 2 for a touchdown.
And they're going to measure this. We've got a player down. That's Dan Copen.
Outstanding center from Boston College, Dan Copen. I would think he's going to be short by about a foot or more.
Yeah, I think so. I think you kick the field goal. You have to go up by 11. That means two touchdowns, or one touchdown, a two-point conversion, and a field goal to tie.
Yeah, a field goal could be the lights-out shot with 7 minutes to go. Coach Belichick and his Patriots have the bye week next week. Then they go to Buffalo to play the Bills. Well, the Patriots with fourth down coming up and less than a yard for the first down. For those of you expecting to see 60 minutes, you're watching the NFL on CBS and the game between the world champion New England Patriots and the Arizona Cardinals. I'm Don Crickey along with Steve Tasker. Our score is New England 20, Arizona 12. 60 minutes will be seen in its entirety immediately following this game, except on the West Coast.
And it shows you what we know, Don. Bill Belichick is going to go for this on fourth and short. I think the plus side of going for it right here, if you get it, this game may well be over.
Brady went to the sideline. He has a tremendous influence and input into the offensive game plan, and also is free to check off and make a change.
Bill Belichick is all the way down to the 15-yard line watching this play as close as he can possibly get to it.
He might wait to see if they jump. It's going to be a long count. That's the call. He's going for a long count, hoping the Cardinals would jump. They're not by until they'll kick the field goal.
He gave it a shot. And they take the delay. No big deal. It's still a chip shot field goal for Vinatieri. And that's, you know, he's trying to win any way he can. You really got to tip your hat. Give his guys a chance. Stay disciplined. Maybe get a free penalty. Never misses a trick.
Patriots came out here Thursday. They had a full practice in the heat. It was over 100 on Friday. Another walkthrough yesterday. This would be a 24-yard field goal. They certainly stay in hotels befitting champions.
Yeah, it was a nice spot.
Here is the field goal by Vinatieri, drilled up and through. And so the Patriots build their lead. Now 23-12. They'll kick off in a moment. We're back at Sun Devil Stadium. The Cardinals ready now to take the kickoff as Emmitt Smith stands on the sidelines waiting to come in. They're probably going to be firing the ball now down by this margin, and here comes Scobie from the three. Josh Scobie from Kansas State runs the ball and gets it out across the 20-yard line. Which quarterback wide receiver combination is the best in the NFL? Is it Bulger and Holt of the Rams, Culpepper and Moss of the Vikings, Maddox and Ward of the Steelers, Manning and Harrison of the Colts, McNabb and Owens of the Eagles, Palmer and Johnson of Cincinnati, or maybe today it's Brady and McGinnis?
Yeah.
Cast your vote at NFL.com. McCown is 11 of 20 for 145 yards. He's been intercepted twice. Throw, and the ball is slapped back at him. Now, while we have a moment, let's go to New York and to Greg Gumbel to see what the Jets and the Chargers are doing. Greg.
Jets are having themselves a nice old time today. Don, one-yard touchdown pass. Chad Pennington to Chris Baker. How about Pennington today? 22 of 29 for 258 yards and two touchdowns. Jets comfortably ahead with 2 minutes to play. Back to you, Don and Steve.
Thank you, Greg. And the Jets en route to a 2-0 start. And the statistics show if you start 2-0, your chances of making the playoffs, I think, are like 63%.
Yeah, he's still even a little better than that. Yeah, that's and 0-2, it goes the other direction, too.
15%. Start 0-2, your chance of making the playoffs is 15%. Another nice breakup. Asante Samuel, another good young defensive back who can play inside or outside.
Oh, there you go. We were just talking about that. Hey, it's nice how that works. 15%, 0-2.
I saw Scott Pioli before the game, the vice president of player personnel of the Patriots, the NFL executive of the year. I asked him about the problem stopping the run against the Colts, and he was quite confident that the Patriots had that fixed. And looking at Emmitt Smith, the leading rusher with 13 carries for 30 yards. That's correct.
They got it fixed. And they were not concerned when we spoke to them on Friday. They felt like they had a handle on things and felt very good about this game.
McCown, well, he just puts it up for grabs. Here is a short thrown ball, and Fitzgerald comes back at the ball.
It's not going to make any difference. They're still going to have to punt the football away. And this, the Cardinals, at moments, parts of this game looked very good. They looked like they were going to compete, maybe even stay in the game and steal it from the New England Patriots. But here late in the game, the New England Patriots just outdistancing the Cardinals. They've got too much for them to handle at this point. And McCown is just trying to stay alive, trying to move the chains, and just can't get it done.
Well, I tell you, as defensive strategists and tacticians, the Patriots are unequaled in the NFL. Here's a Troy Brown.
And again, a good coverage. Dennis Green lauds his special teams players. He said, if our offense and defense played like our special teams guys, we'd be a playoff team.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by CDW, the right technology right away. And by Bud Light, fresh, smooth, real. It's all here.
New England 23, Arizona 12, 5:14 to play in the game. The Patriots looking to extend their winning streak to 17 straight games. Over the years, five NFL teams have won 18 games in a row. The 97-98 Denver Broncos were the most recent. Patriots will be going for records, and here is Corey Dillon turning the corner as he is out of bounds at about the 38-yard line. This Wednesday, Gary Sinise and Melina Canicaretti star in a new drama from Jerry Bruckheimer and the producers of CSI. Don't miss CSI New York. Series premiere Wednesday at 10, 9 Central on CBS.
If the Cardinals defense thought they got a lot of Corey Dillon up to this point, they are going to get a heavy dose of him now. The New England Patriots are going to hand him the football and just try and stay on the field, grind out first downs, and let the clock become their friend.
Well, Corey's quite happy to get it all day long. Here's his 29th carry of the day. A tackle breaker, as Belichick said. He gets the yards after the hit we haven't been getting prior to him coming here. And as we mentioned earlier when talking to Dillon, he said when he came to the Patriots, he was wondering if the grass is greener. He said he found out when he got to New England.
It's pretty green.
It's pretty green, he said.
And you see there the difference in time of possession, and that's a testament to their running game and Corey Dillon and their offensive line. Plus the fact that they've got a quarterback that never got greedy, never tried to go for the big play, always took what was there, and they didn't make that many mistakes. And that's what it comes down to, and you end up leading by 11 with 4 minutes to go.
Steve, one scouting report has of Brady, the most impressive thing about him is where he puts the football. He puts it in front of his receiver, giving him room to catch and run. Seattle and Tampa Bay doing battle down in Florida. For more on that, let's go back to Greg Gumbel.
Don, that battle is done, and the Bucs lose the fight. Matt Hasselbeck watching pump fake. That gets Corwin Robinson wide open, 27 yards and a touchdown, and Seattle knocks off the Bucs 10-6. The Buccaneers start the season 0-2, Don and Steve.
Thank you, Greg. And if you want an early line favorite for the NFC Super Bowl team, it has to be Seattle because the Seahawks start out 2-0 and they've won both games on the road. That means they play 8 of their last 14 in the Great Northwest where they don't lose often.
Yeah, it's tough to go on the road in the NFL, particularly late in the year, particularly if you get a team like Seattle who's playing well. Their fans start to show up. They start to steamroll people. And anytime you can go on the road and win, just like the Patriots did today early in the season, it's a huge boost for your franchise.
Second down arises. See the timeout count. Patriots have three. That's the last thing they want now is to call timeout. With 3:53 to play. Dillon the eye back. Dillon the ball carrier. Taken down for no gain. Now a timeout is being signaled for by the Arizona Cardinals with 3:48 to play.
Tonight on CBS.
Tonight on 60 Minutes, how does a coach lead his team to the Super Bowl? Bill Belichick and John Fox know, and they'll tell it to 60 Minutes. Then it's a night of drama beginning with Cold Case, followed by CSI Miami, and Without a Trace on a special night. It's all here tonight on CBS, America's most watched network.
And there you see the eighth career 150-yard-plus game. And that's exactly why they got him. They wanted a back that they could hand the football to 25 to 35 times a game and get that kind of production out of him. And that makes Tom Brady's day a little better, makes the defense's day a little better, makes Bill Belichick's day a little better. I mean, if you've got a back like that and you put him on the defending world champions, wow.
You win and you move on, as Brady says. They'll be moving on to their bye week, so how do you think the Bills will feel? It looks like they're going to start at 0-2, and they have the Patriots coming in with Belichick having 2 weeks to prepare. Bills have no offense. They have a championship-quality defense. Here's a long ball. Yes. Off the outstretched hands of Troy Brown. Guy with as good a hands as there is in the NFL, a superior route runner now in his 12th year out of Marshall. He was the eighth round pick of the Patriots the year that Bledsoe was the number one pick in the league for New England. What's the matter with the Bills' offense?
Might start at quarterback.
Just got no production from their offense. Patriots punting the ball. This guy's been a good acquisition. Josh Miller, happy to be back. He played at Arizona as a collegian in Tucson. And he hits it beautifully inside the 5-yard line. So Bethel Johnson, 81, is down there to down the ball. A 53-yard punt and no return. Thursday on CBS, critics call the new Survivor a triumph. Last week, the women beat the men, but coming up this Thursday, the guys are out for revenge. Don't miss a minute of Survivor Vanuatu. That's Thursday at 8, 7 Central, here on CBS.
I think the interesting thing about this game, you wonder, but you got to know it's been a factor. The heat's always a factor out here in Arizona. And the Patriots start this game, it's 109 on the field, and now it's below 90. That's been a huge factor in the fact that the New England Patriots have stayed in this game and been as good in the fourth period as they were in the first.
McCown standing in. Again, the ball is slapped at the line of scrimmage. He is just unable to move his offense against this Patriot defense. And so are a lot of quarterbacks.
Yeah, he's not the first quarterback to be befuddled by a Belichick defense, but certainly he's the latest. And Dennis Green, when he came in, said, "This is my guy. I can win with him." And Dennis Green has been to the playoffs with 7 different quarterbacks in Minnesota. I mean, this is a guy that can win with a quarterback who isn't his number one quarterback, or a quarterback who's come in because of injuries.
And McCown's 10 years. He had 8 playoff teams in Minnesota. Dennis Green did. Here's a throw over the middle, and Fitzgerald catches the ball, works ahead. Linesman comes in. He's going to be short of the first down. There's an 8-yard pickup on the play. Ty Poole makes the stop for New England. Another team to watch in the AFC as the early season unfolds is Jacksonville. Rabel left early.
And that's going to be a first down.
What a pickup he was.
Yeah, you're right.
He's playing special teams for the Steelers, and he comes in as like a all-pro quality linebacker, 3-down backer. He can play the run and the pass.
And this now, Vrabel says it's going to go against the Cardinals.
Defense, unabated to the quarterback, offside, 5-yard penalty. The result of the penalty, first down.
You're right, Don. He is the quintessential free agent that the New England Patriots pride themselves on being able to grab. He's a kind of an in-between guy, but the one thing you talk about in-betweeners, one thing that all those guys have is the ability to be versatile. And Bill Belichick loves those kind of guys. Guys you can ask to do more than one thing. Guys you can do things that are unexpected with. And the unexpected is what Bill Belichick prides his team on.
Well, they maximize their roster through the Patriots, using guys at multiple positions if they can. Here's McCown throwing downfield. The receiver was bumped, and a marker's down.
Ty Lye on the coverage, working against Carl Williams.
Illegal contact against an eligible receiver. Defense number 24. 5-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Right here, you'll watch as it passed 5 yards down the line of scrimmage. And there, you can't do that. You can't put your hand out and chuck him. Even that small contact is not allowed.
It didn't seem like much, but that's calling it tight. It's not a new rule. It's just a tighter application.
And that's the rule. I mean, and that's the difference this year. Last year, they would look the other way, wouldn't think that it would bother the receiver. Now they'll call that. And that is the difference this year.
His back foot tries to get the ball downfield and doesn't come close. He was looking at Nate Poole. He and Nate Poole had some connection, though, on the final play of the season last year when they hit for a touchdown to beat the Vikings and knock Minnesota out of the playoffs.
I think here with 2 minutes 50 left in the game, I think the Cardinals, I think, have forgotten about the run game. And you'd say, well, for good reason. But you know what? Even in this situation, you've got to give your team a chance to be successful. And if you can break off an 8 or 10 yard run against a 3-man rush, you need to do it in this situation, particularly if you've got a quarterback who's struggling.
He's struggling. Second and 10, gets a look, fires to the wrong side of his receiver.
Well, now, you know what, Don, that's just Nathan Poole's got to make that catch. I mean, you got a quarterback who may not have had the best game, but you know what? The rest of the club is on the team, too. And if you make a throw like that at this point of the game, you've got to make that catch.
Ball position at the 22-yard line. We talked about Brady in the scouting report, how he puts the ball right in the right place. His goal time, Brady says, is to put it a foot in front of his receiver so he can catch and keep running. And McCown is just trying to get his receiver's hands any way he can. It's been a constant. Here's a man. This is the junior varsity against the all-star team. This guy's just not ready to play against this level.
Yeah, you cannot throw the football through a body. And he's done that. He's had 4 footballs batted down at the line of scrimmage, and now one when he's out in the middle of the football field and he throws it right into the face of a defender. You can't do that. And you see Bill Belichick's going to take a timeout. They're going to leave. They got a substitution problem because the Patriots wanted to leave their regular defense on the field and not put their punt return unit. They didn't communicate that well to their players, and they got caught with too many people on the field, so he called the timeout.
Yep, expecting that they'll do something on fourth down from the punt position to throw the ball. It's Premier Monday on CBS, beginning with Still Standing and Listen Up, starring Jason Alexander. Then don't miss the Emmy Award-winning Everybody Loves Raymond and the hit comedy 2 1/2 Men, followed by Monday's number one show, CSI Miami. Plus, John Kerry joins Dave on The Late Show. A night of premieres Monday right here on CBS. Now we have a changing of the guard on the field as new units come in and the Patriots set up for a punt.
And I think they're going to leave McCown on the field now. They're going to try and go for it. I think you got to. If you want to give yourself a chance to win, you got to leave him on, let him go for it on fourth down.
Patriots led early 7-0 on a Brady to Graham touchdown pass. Extended on the same combination to 14-0 in the second quarter, led 14-6 at the half, now lead at 23-12.
You know, Dennis Green, he may not expect his team or think they may get this, but you know what? I think he's trying to find something out about some of his players. It's 4th and 10, and they need to stay on the football field, and he's putting it right in their lap saying, you better get it done. And this is a team that has 21 new faces on their roster, and they continually add and evaluate other players on the waiver wire, as all teams who are trying to rebuild do.
Fourth down, going for it from the shotgun. The Max Protect, Patriots bring blitzers. McCown, good feet, but nowhere to go. Almost picked. Ty Poole had his hands on the ball. Throwing across his body was McCown. And the Patriots take over already in field goal range, should they so choose.
You know, if you're the Cardinals at this point, your head coach is evaluating you even now. I mean, this is almost like a preseason game. When you're a team, when you're a head coach and you're trying to rebuild some things and you're trying to create a new culture in the locker room and you're trying to make your team think like winners instead of like losers, you're going to take some advantages of situations like this. And I'm not saying it will happen, but you're going to see some new faces on this roster that are here now are going to be replaced.
Well, they call his training camp, Steve, Camp Fear, because Dennis Green he'll make changes.
Dennis Green has never been afraid to make a tough decision, ever.
Running play gives us a chance to tell you that the executive producers of the NFL on CBS are Sean McManus and Tony Petitti. Today's game was produced by David Winner and directed by Kathy Barreto. The senior producer of CBS Sports and the NFL Today is Eric Mann. The director is Bob Matina. Coordinating producer of CBS Sports is Harold Bryant. The associate director of today's game is Sean Gerchikoff. Broadcast associate is Kamani Morales. And the technical manager is Rick Godwin. Technical director is Colby Bourgeois. And the audio supervisor is Patrick Thornton. We thank them all. The men and women of CBS Sports. Thanks to our spotter Bill George and Dave Trattner, and to spotters Bob Kaufman and Peter West.
There's one place you don't want to be when this game is over, Don, and that's in the Arizona Cardinals locker room. Dennis Green will not mince words.
I tell you, he hasn't got a bad football team. He's just not a bad football team.
No, he doesn't. But he, believe me, he's going to have a plan when this team, the game is over, and he's going to want players that are going to implement that plan.
Well, one of the reasons the Bidwells hired him, he has a history of turning people around. There's a Harrison, but Dennis Green turned around the Northwestern program, the Stanford program. He went to Minnesota, had a playoff team his first year with the Vikings, and eight playoff teams in 10 years, starting seven different quarterbacks.
All they need to do is give him support, and it'll happen.
Corey Dillon runs the ball on the clock. Dillon now up to 31 carries for the day for 156 yards. We'll be back to the Valley of the Sun, where it's overcast, in a moment. Bill Belichick and his Patriots working the ball. They run it down, and now they have new running back in there, Rabi Abdullah, who they picked up as a free agent, former running back from Lehigh.
And with that first down, that's going to give them the opportunity to almost run out this clock.
And looking at the scoreboard today, Steve, we see the Patriots on their way to a 2-0 start. Also in the AFC, off to a 2-0 start is Jacksonville. Some of the surprises, Kansas City, which won 13 straight games or something like that. Then they went 12, I guess 12 in a row last year. They are 0-2. Losing at Denver and losing at home today to Carolina. See the production of Corey Dillon, a day just like he likes it, pounding away all day long. And the countdown has begun as the Patriots are moving towards their 17th win in a row.
The only down part of this game for the Patriots may be the fact that they lost Branch on this return. You'll see right here, watch his legs as a guy comes in. That's his own player trying to make the tackle and flips him over. That was Stephen Neal, the offensive lineman. He did not return to the game.
Bill Belichick will be happy to leave the Valley of the Sun with their uniforms and an impressive win. They were conditioned to play well all day long, a couple of mistakes. So Belichick and his Patriots move to 2-0 on the start of this season and 17 consecutive wins. As Dennis Green said, six wins in a row are rare in this league. What they're doing is unbelievable. So the final numbers are in, and the Patriots win it 23-12. The great Emmitt Smith, a first ballot Hall of Famer. This is probably his last year and the last year of his contract. And there is two Michigan quarterbacks. Tom Brady talking to rookie John Navarre. Now for Steve Tasker, this is Don Crickey saying so long from Sun Devil Stadium, where the final score is the Patriots 23 and the Cardinals 12. Tonight on 60 Minutes. 60 Minutes coming up next, and then it's a night of drama beginning with Cold Case, followed by CSI Miami and Without a Trace. Vinatieri leaves the field, a victor again with his Patriot teammates. A big day for Corey Dillon. You've been watching the NFL on CBS, and we thank you for being with us.